Shot number five, Noah Perio. For the Explorers, the bottom of the first inning, no runs on no hits, no errors, and no runner left on base. After one inning of play, the score is 4-0, and the Laredo Lemurs 1. All right, fans, it's now time to direct your attention to the right field line, where Hannah Terry has decided to take on the challenge of Bryson Slider. Since Slider has an extra uniform on, we thought it would only be fair if Hannah had to wear an air uniform as well. And then Slider will start at the right field foul line, round center, and head for the finish line at the left field foul line. Are you ready? On your mark, get set, go! Oh, Slider jumped out to an early lead there by cheating. It looks like Hannah's doing her best to catch right up here. Down the stretch they come, Slider's got a pretty big lead. Oh, Hannah's catching up.
All right, baseball fans, thanks for sticking with us. I know it's been a long recovery here, but we're finally on the air here in Sioux City. And let's go ahead and get you the starting lineups as the Lemurs and the Sioux City Explorers have already played one inning. So we'll go ahead and get you the information. And we got to send out a quick tweet here. I know I'm only one person listening, but we'll go ahead and send this out. Get you up to date on what's been going on with the Laredo Lemurs and the Sioux City Explorers. Coming up to the plate, though, is going to be Kevin Taylor. He'll be followed up by Jared Medeiros and then Luke Bailey. So that's the first three as we go to the second inning. It's 1-0 Laredo as we go to the top of the second inning. And looks like a couple of guys, the second baseman and the shortstop, trying to fix the bag over there at second base. So that should give us a little time here maybe to review what happened in the first inning. Ty Morrison reached on a single. He ended up stealing second base. Devontre Richardson popped out to second. And then Dustin Geiger reached on a single. That sent Morrison over to third. And then Dennis Phipps hit a sack fly to bring home Ty Morrison. And that gave the Lemurs the 1-0 lead that we have right now in the ballgame. Here's the pitch to Kevin Taylor. So let's set everything up for you. Eric Wunderkemper is the starting pitcher tonight for Sioux City. So he's out there on the hill. And he'll wind and throw. And that one swung in on a ground ball. Hard hit into right field. Kevin Taylor with a base hit in his first at bat tonight. And that's going to bring up Jared Medeiros. So it's 1-0 Laredo. They scored a run in the first. Matt Lucen threw in the bottom of the first inning for the Lemurs. He walked the first batter, but Matty Johnson tried to steal second base, and he was thrown out by the catcher, Luke Bailey. And then the next two batters got out. Michael Lang struck out, and Noah Perillo ended up flying out to center field. So there you have it. There's your update, and you're caught up. A base hit here by Kevin Taylor, and we're ready to go. So Eric Wunderkemper out there on the mound. We'll go and give you the defensive lineup for Sioux City here in just a second. With a runner at first base and nobody out. And the pitch swung on. That one's fouled back into the screen. So Colwell is in left. Johnson's in center. Lang over there on right. Mendoza's playing third base. Perillo at short and Court playing second. Patron's at first base and Coach behind the plate for this ball game. So Sioux City is on the field. The Laredo Lemurs are at the plate with Jared Medeiros taking his hacks. Yeah, the oddest thing happened. You know, we run a broadcast online, so it's hard to get it going if the computer decides to crash at the last moment. The 0-1 pitch, and that one is fouled into the ground, a bunt attempt there by Jared Medeiros. So the computer crashed right when we started to start the broadcast up. And next thing you know, we were trying to get it up and running. And when it started, when the computer restarted, it decided it had to update something. So it took a little bit longer for us to actually get on the air because we had to wait for the update to complete with the computer. And that's always frustrating, of course, no matter when you're trying to get on a computer and you're trying to, and it has to update itself before you can actually start things up. A little frustrating. So I apologize for all that. It's 1-0 Lemurs, though, and he didn't miss too much. Missed an inning. We're back here in the top of the second inning right now. Werde Kemper up there on the mound. He's a right-handed pitcher. And he sets. He'll throw home, and that's a fastball that misses low and outside. So Medeiros batting in the seventh spot here this evening. Luke Bailey is on deck for the Laredo Lemurs. Medeiros starting the day batting 181 for the Laredo Lemurs. Runner at first base is Kevin Taylor. And Werde Kemper peeks over his shoulder. He looks at Taylor. A couple of head nods, and now the throw home. A breaking ball that comes boring in on the young man, Jared Medeiros. He just barely moves his hands in enough to make sure that the ball did not hit him. Two balls and two strikes. So Sioux City's up in this series. They have a 2-1 lead. Sioux City won the first game of the series. The Lemurs won the second. And Sioux City won the second game. And the second game was only a 5-inning game because the rain ended up coming. Well, they played into the sixth, but the game gets reverted back to the fifth inning because the rain came and they were not able to complete the sixth. Here comes the 2-2 delivery. Swung in a line drive to the shortstop, just over the glove of Perillo. That one goes into left center field. It'll be a base hit. Kevin Taylor will move up to second base, and Medeiros is in at first with a base hit. For Medeiros, that's his 14th hit of the year. Perillo jumped high in the air, and the ball just barely was over the mitt. If Perillo would have had an outfielder's mitt, he probably would have been able to catch that ball, but of course he's using an infielder's mitt, and it ends up in left center field for a base hit. So here's Luke Bailey with nobody out coming up to the plate. Lemurs up 1-0, trying to extend that lead right now. And they got their eye on trying to tie up this series before getting out of town. The Lemurs head home, and we'll have a day off tomorrow to travel. They ought to be pulling into Laredo sometime in the late evening. Bunt shown by Bailey. He pulls back, and it's a fastball right on the outside corner, right at the thigh. No balls and one strike. So your official game time, I know you missed that part. It was 7:09 is when we actually got started, and it was 85 degrees. At game time here in Sioux City at Lewis and Clark Park. No balls and one strike. 1-0 Lemurs. Runners at first and second base. Let's see if Bailey tries to lay down another bunt. He squared on the last pitch. So Werde Kemper looking into the catcher coach. Coach will set up outside. Here's the pitch. The bunt shown. It's bunted right back to the pitcher. Nope, the pitcher gives way, and now he decides to field it. He'll throw over to first base, and they get the out at first. Everybody else moves up, so Taylor up to third base, Medeiros up to second, and the sacrifice goes 1-4, and there's one down, and runners at second and third now for the Laredo Lemurs. Well, that'll bring up Jayudy Valdez back into the lineup after a couple of days off. And Jayudy Valdez had been struggling at the plate, and the Lemurs looking to break him out of that, so they give him some time off to try to recover, try to heal himself up a little bit if he's got any dings, and try to refocus his mind. 1-0 Lemurs, runners at second and third. Jayudy Valdez has one hit in his last 27 at-bats, but that one hit is a home run. Here's the set by Werde Kemper. He'll throw, and that's a breaking ball that misses low and outside. That home run ended up coming against the Amarillo Thunderheads, and it helped beat Amarillo 6-4. So one ball and no strikes to Jayudy Valdez. Over there at third base for Laredo's Kevin Taylor. He reached on a single. Jared Medeiros is at second base. He also reached on a single. One ball and no strikes. So Werde Kemper gets the sign. He'll set out in front of the chest and deliver. A fastball inside. Two balls and no strikes. So over the last couple of days, we've had some heavy humidity here in the area. And of course, we ended up getting rain over the last 2 days as well. But the humidity is a little bit lower today. The temperature is a little bit lower as well. So it turned out to be a really, really comfortable day here in Sioux City. Not quite as bad as it has been over the first 3 days that we're here. Two balls and no strikes. And the set and the throw home. Swung on, and that one's dribbled up the third baseline foul. Judy Valdez working as the designated hitter. Ty Morrison on deck for the Laredo Lemurs, the hot hitting Ty Morrison. So the Lemurs would love to get to him right now. Give him an opportunity to swing the bat with runners in scoring position. But Judy Valdez first, he has a chance to clean off the bases. Two balls and one strike to Judy. Judy Valdez was 17 years old when he was signed by the San Diego Padres as a non-drafted free agent. Here's the 2-1. Swung on and tipped into the ground. So a 2-2 pitch is coming up next. Valdez spent 9 seasons in the Padres organization. Ended up hitting 252 with 56 home runs in that time. So he's out of the batter's box. He tightens up his batting gloves. And he'll walk back up to the right side of the box and dig in. J.D. Valdez taking his time here. He'll take a practice swing. Well, he's lucky that they don't have a time clock on him here. He would have been fined in the major leagues. Two balls and two strikes. And the 2-2 delivery swung on, and that's fouled off. And that ends up hitting the mask of the home plate umpire, I believe. He took his mask off immediately. He didn't seem to be jarred by it, which is a good thing. We don't want him going down. The umpires today, by the way, Steven Linton behind home plate, Sean Hicks over there at first base, and Mitch Wilson at third. One out, top of the second inning. The Lemurs are up 1-0, but looking to add to that lead. Kevin Taylor's at third base. Jared Medeiros is at second. On a lovely Saturday afternoon. It feels so much like Sunday, though, because we started the series on Wednesday and we're finishing it on Saturday. All the days have been messed up for everybody. We have everybody's asking, what day is it? What day is it? What day is it? Yeah, we're thrown off. Two balls and two strikes. Now J.U.D. Valdez is going to step back out. Werde Kemper going to step off the rubber. So a little game of cat and mouse here going on in the early part of this ball game. So Valdez back into the batter's box. Werde Kemper bent at the waist this time to get the sign. He'll get the set on. And the 2-2. Low and outside. So that's going to make the count full. Three balls and two strikes. And the Lemurs could earn a walk here, which wouldn't be a horrible thing. It would help load up the bases with one out for the Laredo Lemurs. Lemurs are up 1-0. Lemurs doing well in the walks category. In fact, they're currently second in the league in walks with 196 of them. So far today, they have 4 hits. They'd rather rack those up, I'm sure. 3 balls and 2 strikes. The Lemurs pitching staff doing well in the walks category as well. They don't have a lot given up. Here comes the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. There's strike 3. And after a long battle between Judy Valdez and Eric Werdekemper, Werdekemper ends up winning it. That'll create the second out. And coming up to the plate is Ty Morrison. It'll be interesting how they face off against Ty Morrison here. He is a leadoff man, but there is an open bag over there at first. So an easy place to put him and face off against Devontre Richardson. The reason I say that is Ty Morrison has been smoking hot as of late. And even though Devontre Richardson is a good hitter and has hit the ball well lately, you got Ty Morrison up there who's really just scolding it. Here's the pitch, a breaking ball that misses high. Morrison got a base hit in his first at-bat. He's the guy that came in to score run. But coming into this ball game tonight, he ended up with 6 hits and 12 at-bats against Sioux City. So he's batting 500 against the Sioux City Explorers. And he had another at-bat to that. So far he has 7 hits and 13 at-bats against Sioux City. Here comes the 1-0 delivery. And a breaking ball misses inside. So 2 balls and no strikes. 1-0 Lemurs. Taylor at third base. Medeiros is at second. A couple of speedy guys out there on the base pass. So anything that's put into the outfield should score a run if it's a base hit. Of course, there's 2 outs in the inning, so the ball does have to fall to the ground. Taylor waves the bat around. And he's finally ready to go. Word to Kemper. Delivers. That is low for a ball. Three balls and no strikes. So I kind of mentioned this before Morrison even stepped into the batter's box that we might see a pitch around here. Word to Kemper being very careful with a hot hitting Ty Morrison. But Devontre Richardson, no slouch by any means. In fact, once you get into this part of the lineup, they're all pretty good sluggers. The 3-0, a breaking ball misses way outside, and really Werdekemper ended up losing the grip on that one, but ball four nonetheless, and that's going to load the bases now for the Laredo Lemurs. So Devontre Richardson coming up to the plate.
For the Lemurs, left fielder number 10, Devontre Richardson.
And Devontre Richardson popped out to the second baseman in his last at bat. So Richardson into the batter's box for the right side as usual. And he's got the bases loaded to work with. Richardson this year with the bases loaded has had three opportunities to come up to the plate. He's batting 667 in this situation. He takes the breaking ball low and outside. So he's had three at-bats and four RBIs. And like I said, a 667 batting average with the bases loaded. With runners in scoring position, he's batting 333 with 14 RBIs. That's in 39 total at-bats. So the base is loaded and two down. 1-0 Lemurs. Word of Kemper delivers. It's called a strike at the letters. That one on the inside corner. Making it a count of one ball and one strike now to Devontre Richardson. Devontre Richardson starting the day for the Laredo Lemurs, batting 348 overall. He has 23 total RBIs. Nobody holding on the runner at first. And here's a breaking ball that's in and out of the glove of Coach, and it'll just roll slightly over to the right. So he'll be able to corral it pretty easily without Kevin Taylor running down the third base line. So that's going to make it a 2-1 count. And this is definitely a hitter's count here. Word to Kemper. Probably going to have to come in with a fastball. He doesn't want to fall behind 3-1. Dustin Geiger's on deck for the Lemurs. Water to Kemper. He'll set. Here's the pitch. Swung on and a slash down the right field line. Foul. That goes into the Lemurs' bullpen. So evens it up at two balls and two strikes. Lemurs looking for a big base hit here. Devontre Richardson at the plate. Richardson. On the road this year, he's batting 337. Two balls and two strikes. Word of Kemper shakes off a couple of pitches that are thrown down by the catcher. And they finally agree on one. Here's the 2-2. Outside, just by a little bit. And Eric Werdekemper thought they had that one. A couple of players started heading towards the dugout, but they only took a step and realized that it was not going to be called a strike. It was a little bit outside, so Devontre Richardson definitely had a good eye there. Three balls and two strikes, so now everybody's going to be on the move with two outs. So Werdekemper will set. He'll kick. He'll throw. Here's the pitch. Swung on the ground ball up the middle. Here comes Taylor. He's in to score. Right behind him will be Jared Medeiros. He's coming in to score. The ball bounces once and hits Ty Morrison in the head over at third base, and it bounces off his helmet. And then going into second base is Devontre Richardson. The Lemurs have a 3-0 lead and a big base hit by Devontre Richardson with the bases loaded and two down. So Taylor comes in from third base, and in from second is Jared Medeiros. And the Lemurs have scored here twice in the inning, and they're looking for more with Dustin Geiger coming up to the plate. So Richardson over there at second. And over at third base is Ty Morrison for the Laredo Lemurs. So Geiger can come up with a big hit here. The Lemurs can get a couple of more runs. 3-0 Lemurs. The pitch, breaking ball, stays high. One ball and no strikes. Well, working under here underneath some bright sunshine. There is a little shade down there on the field. It's slowly going to creep up to the pitching mound. And the 1-0 delivery is low. Two balls and no strikes. The natives are getting restless here. Both of those pitches have missed, but they're looking for a little home cooking here in Sioux City. I know you got the crowd mic that's right over the people here in Sioux City doing some belly aching about the calls. Here comes the 2-0. The pitch. That one's a strike on the outside part of the plate. Two balls and one strike. 3-0 Laredo. So over there at third base with his lead is Ty Morrison. Devontae Richardson is off the bag at second. And Werde Kemper kicks and throws home. A breaking ball swung on and missed. Two balls and two strikes now to Dustin Geiger. Geiger swinging at a pitch that might have been a little bit off the plate. Geiger starting the day for the Lemurs, batting 239, but overall he's batting 308 on the season. He's played 19 games. This is actually his 20th game with the Laredo Lemurs. He's got 17 hits and 71 at-bats. And the 2-2 swung on and a pop-up over to the right side in foul territory. Patron over there. He's going to make the catch, and he's going to run into the railing right with his rib cage, and he falls to the ground. He does make the catch, and that's going to do it for Laredo. And Patron pops up. He's going to head over to the dugout. Now, good thing he got up there. He banged into the side fence, and the side fence goes up about 4.5 feet, and he ended up hitting himself right in the ribs with the railing over there down the right field line. Well, he caught the ball before he hit the fence, but his momentum took him into it. So he held on to the baseball, and that's going to do it for the Lemurs. But they strike here. They come up with two runs on three hits. There are no errors and two left. We're going to the bottom of the second inning. Lemurs up 3-0. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E, that's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's gotta be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Do you want to sit in a car for 7 hours, risk a flat tire, traffic, or highway construction delays? Fly direct from Laredo International Airport to Dallas-Fort Worth on American Airlines. From Dallas, you can change planes and take a flight to Tokyo, London, or even Rio de Janeiro. With 4 daily arrivals and departures, American Airlines is sure to have a connection that works best for you. So avoid spending hours in the car or risk an accident on the highway or even a flat tire. Fly in comfort from Laredo International Airport. Visit AA.com for details and to book a reservation.
Uni-Trade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Uni-Trade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Uni-Trade.
There's a reason why Popeyes creates some of the best tasting chicken in the world. We were born in New Orleans, Louisiana, the land of good fun and great cooking. Spicy flavor is a way of life in New Orleans, and everything we make reflects it. From our Popeyes bona fide chicken and handcrafted tenders to our home-style mashed potatoes with Cajun gravy and our soft, buttery biscuits, everything we make is made with care and served up fresh. Only at Popeyes.
3-0 Laredo as we go to the bottom of the second inning. And coming up for the Sioux City Explorers, it's going to be Ryan Court, Tommy Mendoza, and then Matt Coach coming up to the plate. So Matt Lucen back up on the hill. He's been given a nice lead. He'll throw here, and that's a fastball away. One ball and no strikes. Matt Lucen will bring a fastball, a slider, a curveball, and a changeup to the plate. And Lucen starting the day with a record of 2 wins and 3 losses on the season, the 1-0. A breaking ball hits the inside corner for a strike. Lucen with a 4.71 ERA over 11 games. All of them starts for the Laredo Lemurs. One ball and one strike. And the 1-1 pitch swung on and fouled away up and over the fence off to the right. Matt Lucen made his last start for the Laredo Lemurs against the Amarillo Thunderheads. Lemurs won the game 6-4, but Lucen did not get a decision. He only pitched in four innings, gave up 3 runs through that time. He ended up giving up 5 hits and walked 3 batters. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. Low for a ball, 2 balls and 2 strikes. Might have been a little bit outside as well. 3-0 Lemurs. Matt Luson's previous outing before the game against Amarillo was against Wichita, and he had a great outing on July 8th. The 2-2 pitch, a fastball called strike three, and Ryan Court goes down looking. Second strikeout on the night for Matt Luson, and Tommy Mendoza is going to be the next batter. Yeah, against Wichita, Luson, like I said, he had his best game of the year. Went seven complete, did not allow a run, and only three hits. He walked four and struck out four that night. A really solid outing there for the young man, Matt Luson. Matt Luson, like I said, has made 11 starts. The Lemurs have lost only four of those games that Matt Luson has started in. Here's the pitch to Mendoza. Mendoza will see a pitch miss low and outside. One ball and no strikes. And Lemurs took losses to Amarillo and Kansas City on the 13th of June and the 18th of June. And then they lost against Grand Prairie on July 3rd. And here's the next pitch in there for a strike. And against Wichita on July 8th. Even though Matt Luson pitched that great game against Wichita on July 8th, he didn't earn a decision that day, and the Lemurs ended up losing the game. Now timeout's called. Luson was going to go into the windup, and Mendoza called timeout at the plate. 3-0 Laredo. Last game of this series, and then the Lemurs are heading home. The 1-1 pitch. Low, ball two. So two balls and one strike. Tommy Mendoza in the series against the Laredo Lemurs only has two hits. He's picked up two hits in nine at-bats against Laredo. Here comes the 2-1 delivery. Swung on and a pop-up over to the left side. Silverio will creep into foul territory. He's got this one under control. He'll make an easy catch, and that'll do it for Mendoza. Two down, and Matt Coach is going to be the batter. Well, the shade getting ever so closer to the pitching mound. The shade is, well, the sun is behind the third base side. So the shade is going to creep up on the pitcher's mound from that side. And might get, throw some of the batters off at the plate. The ball is going to be going from the bright sunshine into the shade very quickly. 3-0 Laredo. Into the batter's box, Matt Coach. He's the catcher tonight. The late kick and the throw home by Luson. And it's low for a ball. Matt Coach in the series. He's played in all three games. He has two hits and 10 at-bats. He has scored a run. 1-0. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swung in and a foul ball off to the right. So for the Lemurs, they have three runs on five hits in the ball game. And so far, Sioux City has not picked up a base hit yet. Matty Johnson did reach back in the first inning, and he ended up getting thrown out stealing by the strong arm of Luke Bailey. One ball and one strike. Luson peers over the mitt. He goes into the full windup. Here's the pitch. Just misses away. That one actually probably hit the chalk on the other side where the left-handed batter's box is. Now a 2-1 pitch. Luson shakes off Bailey once. Bailey will set up away and crouch down really low, and the pitch is swung on and popped up over to the right, but it's going to curve out of play. Matt Coach out of Manhattan Beach, California. He's 6 foot even, 200 pounds. He played his college baseball at Loyola Marymount University. He was drafted by the Minnesota Twins back in the 12th round of 2011. And he spent four seasons with the Twins organization. Two balls and two strikes. And Luson will wind and throw. Swung on and a fly ball hit into right center field. This one's hit pretty well. Phipps is going back. He gets into the gap. He'll backpedal and make the catch. And that's going to do it. Three up and three down for the Sioux City Explorers. We're going to head to the top of the third. The Lemurs are up 3-0. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Chavarrias Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology, trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit ChavarriasPlumbing.com and go Lemurs!
Falcon Bank and the Laredo Lemurs are a winning combination. At Falcon, they know what counts. Personalized service, attention to detail, and genuine commitment to helping customers achieve their dreams. Falcon Bank, guided by faith, grounded by family, and committed to you.
Need a little spark in your life? Then come on out to Uni-Trade Stadium for Friday Night Fireworks. Tickets start as low as $5, and you'll get to see great baseball and great fireworks all in one night. To get tickets, call 956-7-LEMURS or go online at LaredoLemurs.com. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas, as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. And the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
3-0 Lemurs. We go to the third inning. If you were around yesterday when the rain came, if you were paying attention to what we were doing here with the Laredo Lemurs and the Sioux City Explorers, you might have been able to see the field through the video screen. And it was very wet, wasn't it? It was pretty drenched out there, but they've gotten it in good playing order here for today's ball game. Pretty impressed with what they did. Remember yesterday they were not able to get the tarp on when the wind came. If they would have tried to get the tarp on with the wind blowing, the wind would have been blowing up over the right field wall and would have had a big kite out there for everybody to attach themselves to and fly away with. Here's the pitch to Dennis Phipps. Phipps takes a strike on the outside corner, a fastball there to start things off. Dennis Phipps in the first inning hit a sack fly that drove in Ty Morrison. 3-0 Lemurs. So overall, the field looks pretty good. Here comes the 0-1 delivery in the dirt, making a count of 1-1. Of course, anytime you have rain coming, you like to make sure you get the tarp on the field to make sure that the infield stays nice and dry. The grass could probably absorb it a whole lot better. But you could really mess up an infield with a lot of rain on it. The 1-1 pitch swung in and a couple of hops over to the shortstop. Perio will charge. Before he hits the lip of the grass, he'll throw over to first base, and it'll be a 6-3 putout for the first out in the inning. Juan Silverio coming up now for the Laredo Lemurs. 3-0 Laredo. So here's a little bit about the starting pitcher tonight, Eric Werdekemper. His last name, by the way, is spelled W-O-R-D-E-K-E-M-P-E-R, Werdekemper. He starts the night with a record of 3 wins and 1 loss, and he's got a 4.90 ERA. He's making his fifth start of the season and his 10th appearance of the year for Sioux City. So Juan Silverio into the batter's box, a right-handed batter for the Laredo Lemurs against a right-handed pitcher. The pitch, a changeup, hits the inside corner. Werdekemper's last outing, he ended up taking a loss against Joplin, going 2 innings and giving up 4 runs. He gave up 2 hits and walked 4 batters. His last win was on July 5th against Sioux Falls. He went 6 in that game, gave up 4 runs on 9 hits. The 0-1, and that one goes way over the head of Juan Silverio. He ducks out of the way. 3-0 Lemurs. Silverio in his last at bat lined out to the shortstop. Werdekemper is a native of Storm Lake, Iowa, which is east of here, and was drafted in the 46th round back in 2005 by the New York Yankees. 1-1. He went to Creighton University in Omaha, Nebraska. The 1-1, swung in a grounder foul. During his 3 seasons with the Toronto Blue Jays, Werdekemper posted a 14-8 record. In his 3 seasons with the New York Yankees. One ball and 2 strikes to Silverio. And the pitch. Swung on and missed. The catcher's going to have to throw the ball down to second base, and it's going to be in time to get the out. So a strikeout and a 2-3 put out. There's 2 down. All right, let's start over on the Werdekemper information. We have some contradicting information on his player page. So we'll go right to Baseball Reference, the source for baseball information. Kevin Taylor into the batter's box for the Laredo Lemurs. Werdekemper now has 2 strikeouts. 3-0 Laredo, 2 outs in the inning. We're in the top of the third. The pitch, high for a ball. So Wordy Kemper was drafted by the Yankees in the 46th round back in 2005 out of Creighton University. He went to high school at St. Mary's High School in Storm Lake, Iowa. The 1-0. A strike on the outside part of the plate. So he spent several years in the Yankees organization. In fact, he was there with the Yankees back in 2005 all the way through 2011. He reached up to AAA. In fact, he played 5 seasons at AAA with 86 total games. The 1-1 delivery swung on and a fly ball hit into center field. Johnson drifting back. He's underneath it. He stands there and makes the catch. And the Lemurs go down in order here in the top of the third. We'll head to the bottom of the third inning. Lemurs up 3-0. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn. Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined. And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
Breakfast speaks for itself here at Whataburger. It's going to be hot, it's going to be fresh.
It's almost like when you were a kid and you wake up in the morning, you can smell mom cooking breakfast.
I like their hash browns.
My favorite is the honey butter chicken biscuit. I like the taquitos.
We have some fresh cracked eggs here.
I like these pancakes because they're fluffy.
I really like the fact that you can get into Whataburger real fast and bring it on the go.
We're cooking breakfast for you at Whataburger.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a 4-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU powers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
All right, the ball goes down to second base, and we're ready to go here in the bottom of the third inning. It's 3-0, Lemurs. Lemurs picked up 1 run back in the first inning, 2 more runs in the second. A lot of singles mixed in there for the Laredo Lemurs. 5 hits tonight already for Laredo. They had 17 hits in that carryover game from Thursday night to Friday night. And now it's the 4th time this year that the Lemurs have picked up 17 hits in one game. That exact same number, 4 times. Pretty amazing. Here's Eno Patron getting ready to step into the batter's box. So it's Patron, Usiak, and Colwell coming up to the plate. And the wind and the throw home, and that is low for a ball. So Matt Lucen, the starting pitcher for the Laredo Lemurs, out there on the hill. I was telling you a little bit about what he's done last time he was up there on the mound. He went to Jacksonville University. He'll throw again on the 1-0 pitch. Swung in a ground ball over to the right side. Ranging for Taylor. Taylor will get there. He'll make the throw over to first base, and it's in time to get the out. 4-3 on the putout, and Dylan Usiak coming up to the plate. Usiak working as the designated hitter tonight. And Usiak, one of the catchers. This is his first at-bat of the night. And in the series, he's 1-for-8. He has struck out twice. So the Lemurs have held him down pretty well. He's got a .233 batting average. He's out of Modesto, California. Bats from the left side. Here's the pitch from the righty, Lucen. That is low for a ball. So Matt Lucen was a Chicago Cubs draft pick back in the 23rd round of 2010. Ended up spending 5 seasons in the Cubs organization. The 1-0 delivery swung in and a high fly ball to left field. That's going to get out of play, though, as it keeps drifting away. Matt Lucen started off in 2010 with the Cubs Arizona League affiliate, and he also played in Boise in 2010. He played with the Boise Hawks at the Northwest League. 1-1. And the pitch. Swung on and a well-hit ball, but very foul. Usiak so far out in front of that one. I believe it was a fly ball that probably got into the parking lot up and over the Lemurs' dugout, and it was hit super well. I don't know how a guy does that, but he just did it. One ball and two strikes. And the pitch. Swung on and tipped into the glove of the catcher, and it's held onto by Luke Bailey, so two down. So the journey for Lucen continued after 2010 through the Cubs organization. He went and played in Peoria in 2011. He also played in Daytona that season and then moved up to double-A ball in Tennessee. In 2012, he saw himself start off in Daytona. And he pretty much pitched there the whole season, 23 games in Daytona, and he put up an 11-5 record and a 4.07 ERA. Here's Tim Colwell, the number 9 hitter. The pitch, low for a ball. In 2013, Lucen back in Daytona, and then he also played in Tennessee. And he played in Tennessee in 2014 before getting released from the Cubs organization, the 1-0. Low for a ball, 2-0, 3-0 Lemurs here. We're in the bottom of the third. So when the Lemurs get home, we'll start playing on Monday night against Joplin. The Blasters will be in town. A very important game for Laredo. The 2-0 pitch swung in a line drive into left field. Moving back on the ball, Richardson. He'll move in a step now and make the catch. But as I was saying, we're going to be on our regular broadcast carrier, American Association Baseball.tv. Well, not a regular one. We always broadcast on YouTube. But for our home games, we prefer that you go over to American Association Baseball.tv and watch the games there. So that's going to do it. 3-3 for the Sioux City Explorers. I just wanted to set that reminder for you. And, of course, we'll be tweeting it out before the ball game starting on Monday night. So 3-3 here for Matt Lucen. He's heading back into the dugout. The Lemurs are heading back up to the plate. They're up 3-0. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epic or chest bumps, touchdown dancing, break dancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Hey, ¿tienes algo que celebrar? ¿Que le salió el primer diente a tu hijo? ¿Que tu abuelita aprendió a tuitear? ¿Que cambiaste tu cheque? La respuesta es la misma. Pues un carnesazo. No importa lo que estés celebrando, lo que importa es que lo celebres. Pues con un carnesazo de HEB. En HEB encuentras gran variedad de cortes a precios bajos y de buena calidad. Carnesazo. Carne asada con ganas. Solo en HEB.
Three nothing, Laredo in the lead, and we go to the top of the fourth inning. Lemurs looking to get out of here with a split against a very tough Sioux City Explorers team. Sioux City starting the day with a record of 37 wins and 16 losses. They're the second best team in the American Association, and the Lemurs looking to make a little bit of a name for themselves. And I've heard the word around here from some of the people up here in the press box that they think this is the best, next best team next to St. Paul and Sioux City themselves. So they like what they see out of the Laredo Lemurs. Here's the pitch from Werdekemper, and that one's a strike right at the letters to Jared Medeiros. Medeiros with a base hit and came in to score run back in the second inning. 3-0 Laredo. So a little bit more about Eric Werdekemper. Told you he was in the Yankees organization, and he was there for quite a while. Here's the pitch, swung in a ground ball into left field, a base hit. And look at Jared Medeiros go. Two base hits for the young man today. And Luke Bailey coming up to the plate next. And so Werdekemper spent 7 seasons in the Yankees farm system from 2005 through 2011. And he pitched up to the AAA level in 6 out of the 7 seasons. Actually, the AA and AAA level for 6 out of the 7 seasons he was there. So throughout the Yankees system, he started playing with the Gulf Coast Yankees back in 2005 and also played for Staten Island, the Staten Island Yankees back then. Runner at first base and nobody out. Luke Bailey at the plate, and Bailey sees a pitch missed low and outside. That was a breaking ball. Then in 2006, Wardy Kemper went on to pitch for Charleston, the Charleston River Dogs in Charleston, South Carolina. That's in the Sally League, the South Atlantic League. And he also pitched for the Columbus Clippers that year. That's AAA ball, so he made the jump from low A ball to AAA ball that season. Pretty big jump. The 1-0. Swung and missed. He only pitched in one game, though, for Columbus, so he probably was up there and right back down to Charleston very, very quickly. But still a nice jump. The following season, in 2007, he pitched for the Tampa Yankees. That's high A ball in the Florida State League. One ball and one strike. Wardy Kemper looking over at second base. Medeiros with his lead. Medeiros dangles that right arm out in front of him. And the 1-1 delivery. Swung on and a pop-up. Shallow center field coming in. Johnson, the center fielder, looks like he's got a bead on this one as he runs underneath it, puts on the brakes, and makes the catch. One down, and Jeudy Valdez will be the next batter with a runner at first. So after pitching for the Tampa Yankees in 2007, the same year he went on and played for the Trenton Thunder. Double-A ball for the New York Yankees. Trenton Thunder. He was also in the same teams, Tampa and Trenton in 2008. Then he pitched in Trenton and for Scranton Wilkes-Barre. That's in Scranton, PA. I think that's where The Office is supposed to be filmed, right? That's where they placed the TV show The Office, in Scranton, PA. Here's the pitch, swung on and grounded foul up the first baseline. No balls and one strike. He's also pitched abroad a little bit, as Wardy Kemper. He pitched in the Venezuelan Summer League, and he also pitched in the Mexican Pacific Winter League. Pitched there in the Mexican Pacific Winter League a couple of times. So he's all over the Yankees system. He was knocking on the door of the big leagues. The 0-1 pitch swung on and missed. Jeudy Valdez falling behind. No balls and two strikes. 3-0 Lemurs. So this is the second season for Wardy Kemper in independent baseball. He pitched for the Camden River Sharks in the Atlantic League back in 2013. He did not pitch last year. So he's back here with the Sioux City Explorers, which is kind of close to home for him. He's out of Storm Lake, Iowa. No balls and two strikes. The pitch. Swung on and a foul ball up and over the ballpark. As I look up and the lights start flickering to life here at the ballpark, so they've turned on the lights here in Sioux City. We will have night baseball sooner or later. Jeudy Valdez, the number 9 hitter tonight for the Lemurs, struck out in his first at bat. And Eric Wardy Kemper looking in to get the signs from the catcher. And Wardy Kemper peeks over his shoulder, looks over at Jared Medeiros. And a toss over to first base, just a light toss there by Wardy Kemper. Wardy Kemper, by the way, is 31 years old now. And when he was in AAA, he posted a record of 7 wins and 4 losses and a 3.43 ERA through 86 games. At the AA level, he was 7-4 with a 3.31 ERA. No balls and two strikes to Jeudy Valdez. And the set. A couple of head nods, and now the throw. And a breaking ball that gets away from the pitcher, and it goes open over the head of Jeudy Valdez, who has to duck out of the way of that one. That's the second time we've seen that. Juan Silverio had the same issue in his last at-bat, where he had to duck out of the way of the ball coming his way. Top of the fourth inning, 3-0 Laredo. Medeiros creeps off the bag a little bit farther. He started his wheels on the last pitch, but decided to turn him off after he took about 2 or 3 steps. The 1-2 pitch is low and outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes. So Jeudy Valdez taking his time, getting back into the batter's box. Medeiros has 1 stolen base this year for the Laredo Lemurs. And a 2-2 count. He creeps off the bag a little bit further. And the 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball. Swung on, ground ball. Hit down the third baseline, but foul by about a foot down the third baseline. So we'll do it again on another 2-2 pitch coming up. So a 2-2 count, and the Jeudy Valdez asking the home plate umpire. He wants to make sure that's correct. What's up on the scoreboard? So Jared Medeiros with that one complete stolen base, or one successful stolen base. He goes here. The pitch is swung on and hit into right center field. No one's going to get to this one. It's going to go for a long way. In fact, it's going to bounce and keep on rolling out to the warning track. Medeiros is already around third base. He's going to come in to score. Jeudy Valdez is going to go in with a stand-up triple. And it's now 4-0 for the Laredo Lemurs. Jared Medeiros got to scooting and scores all the way from first base. Jeudy Valdez with a stand-up triple. That's his first of the season for the Laredo Lemurs. And, man, that ball was hit very well out to right center field. This is a big ballpark, so the ball had a long way to go out to that corner in right center field. So the Lemurs extend the lead by a run, but there's only one out, and Ty Morrison coming up to the plate, so the Lemurs can get another run for sure. Now the catcher coach is going to head out and talk to Eric Werdekemper. Bullpen action right now for Sioux City. And here comes the manager out of the dugout, Steve Montgomery, so he's going to stroll up to the pitching mound, and actually he's going to make a change. He's going to go get a new pitcher into the ballgame. So while they make a change, we'll go and give you some advertisements here. It's 4-0 Laredo. We're going to the bottom of the fourth inning. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. We're not going to the bottom of the fourth. I was wrong. We're in the top of the fourth inning. Stay tuned. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. Oh, boy.
South Texas families never strike out with Driscoll Health Plan. Catch the value-added services we pitch to our Medicaid members. Enjoy a free membership to specific Boys and Girls Clubs. Receive gift cards for completing Texas healthcare checkups. Restrictions and limitations may apply. Visit us at DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Todos sabemos que podemos lograr más cuando estamos listos. Por eso, decidí matricularme en Texas A&M International University. Quiero un título universitario y las oportunidades que me brindará. TAMIU me ha recibido a mí y a 7,000 estudiantes de todo el mundo. TAMIU me impulsa a ser grande, enciende mi mente y hace mi corazón latir. Imagina las posibilidades cuando eres impulsado por TAMIU.
Inscríbete ahora para verano y otoño. Visita tamiu.edu y sé impulsado.
3-2-1, number one. That's Laredo's number one Chevy dealer. Family Chevrolet turns the best day ever into the best month ever. 15% off, not good enough, but 25% off, now that makes it the best month ever. With over 600 vehicles available, makes it the best pricing ever. 2015 Equinox, 2015 Traverse, not 15, but 25% off. And the best financing rates for the best month ever, 1.9 interest. Family Chevrolet of Laredo.com. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet. Family Chevrolet is the number one volume Chevy dealer for a reason. Every customer rides during our spring cleaning closeout sale with massive price gifts on 600 Chevys. New 2015 Chevy Cruze. How about 25% off MSRP? Wow, that's huge. Or only $199 a month. New 2015 Malibu for only $269 a month. Or 25% off MSRP. Plus 2 years free maintenance and a 100,000-mile warranty. It's a spring cleaning closeout sale happening now at the number one volume Chevy dealer. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to fewer guys with beer bellies, which led to more women attracted to those guys, which led to dates, second dates, wedding bells, and honeymoons, which led to hubbada hubbada, boom, which led to you. Miller Light, attracted to those guys, which led to dates, second dates.
All right, Ty Morrison coming up to the plate. The new pitcher is Anthony Ferrara. Coming into pinch. He's a left-handed pitcher, and the infield's going to come in for the Sioux City Explorers. It's 4-0 Laredo, and a runner at third base, Jeudy Valdez, who just drove in Jared Medeiros. We sit in the top of the fourth inning, and Ferreira is going to pitch. He'll throw, and that one's on the inside corner for a strike. Ferrara with a record of no wins and no losses and a mighty 9.82 ERA. He has pitched in 8 games and has thrown 7 and a third innings, giving up 14 hits, 9 runs, 8 of them have been earned. The 0-1, breaking ball, a curve. That one hits the outside corner for a strike. Ferrara has only struck out 4 batters and has given up a home run, a couple of doubles, and a triple. His against average is .389. No balls and 2 strikes and a runner at third base for the Laredo Lemurs. Here's the pitch from the lefty. Breaking ball swung in and a ground ball over to the second baseman. Court has a tip off of his mitt as it took a wild hop and it goes into center field. Coming in to score for the Laredo Lemurs is Jeudy Valdez. And the Lemurs are up 5-0 in the ball game. And Ty Morrison is over at first base. So with the infield being played in there, the ball gets through and Ryan Court can't handle the wicked hop there. And he gets over, up and over his head. So a base hit up on the board for the Laredo Lemurs. And that's going to be an RBI for Ty Morrison. Second hit of the ball game for Ty Morrison. And he has been on fire in this series for the Laredo Lemurs. He already has two hits today in this ball game. As into the batter's box goes Devontre Richardson with a runner at first. Here's the pitch. A strike on the outside corner. By the way, Morrison with three stolen bases on the season. He picked one up earlier in this ball game. Morrison now has 8 hits in the series. 8 hits in 14 official at-bats. He did walk in his last at-bat before he just picked up this base hit. Devontre Richardson swings and misses through a breaking ball. No balls and two strikes. 5-0 Laredo. Dustin Geiger's on deck. There's one out here in the inning. So Ty Morrison extends his lead. He's got a pretty good lead over there at first base. He's digging in with that back foot, which is his left foot. It's his push-off leg. Here's the 0-2. Swung on and a fly ball into the right field. That's going to keep going foul, though. No balls and two strikes. Anthony Ferrara, currently in his 8th professional season of baseball. His second league and second time in indie ball, though. And this is his first year with the Sioux City Explorers. He's currently 25 years old, and he's at a Riverview High School in Sarasota, Florida. No balls and two strikes. The lefty will freeze Morrison at first base. Now he'll throw home, and it's a breaking ball that misses low and inside. Ferrara was drafted by the St. Louis Cardinals back in the 7th round of the 2008 draft out of high school. He reached as high as double-A ball with Springfield. The Springfield Cardinals, they play in the Texas League. One ball and two strikes. 5-0 Lemurs. Here's the set and the pitch. Swung on a line drive and a right field, a base hit. Devontre Richardson does an inside out job on that pitch. Takes it over to right. And that'll move Morrison up to second base. Richardson in at first with his single. The Laredo Lemurs advance the guys. Now there's two runners on. Dustin Geiger. And that'll bring up Dustin Geiger, the number 3 hitter in the batting order for the Laredo Lemurs. So Geiger in his first at-bat singled back in the first inning. He popped out to the first baseman and foul territory back in the second. If you were listening back then, that's when Patron ended up going into the railing and hitting his rib cage up against the 4.5-foot railing down the right field line as he caught the ball. Here's the pitch to Geiger. Geiger swings and fouls a big one out of the way. So that one gets way out of here. Geiger all over the leaderboard in the American Association. Currently sitting with 10 home runs. That's good for second in the league. Fourth in the league with 24 extra base hits. And fifth in the league with a .546 slugging percentage. No balls and one strike. And the pitch from the lefty swung on, and that's tapped foul at the plate. It hits the plate. It hits Geiger and falls back down to the ground. Dustin Geiger, another Cubs draft pick. There's former Cubs guys all over the American Association, and a couple of them with the Laredo Lemurs. No balls and two strikes to Geiger. 5 runs on 9 hits today for Laredo. We're in the top of the fourth. And the 0-2 delivery. Low and inside, and it gets away from the catcher coach, but it goes up the third baseline, which will keep Ty Morrison anchored over there at second base. So now one ball and two strikes. Dennis Phipps on deck for the Laredo Lemurs if they can get to him. Now the relief pitcher Anthony Ferrara spent the 2014 season with the Springfield Cardinals. He also spent some time with the New Jersey Jackals of the Can-Am League, so he went from affiliated ball to independent ball in the Can-Am League. He started the 2015 season with the River City Rascals of the Frontier League. The 1-2 pitch swung in a ground ball up to the third baseman. Mendoza throws to second for one, back over to first base, and that's going to be a double play. That'll end things here for the Laredo Lemurs, but they strike, and they come up with two runs on four hits. There are no errors and one left. We're going to go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Lemurs up 5-0. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Crowd at the bar making you sweat?
Uh-huh.
Could you use some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in epic nights, maximum refreshment, great times, awesome memories, high fives, smiles, Rocky Mountain refreshment, Blue Mountain refreshment, quadruple epic refreshment, killer parties, and totally refreshed killer parties. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Kaila Norte Suite number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS, creating a new standard in medical transportation. Capital Care EMS, the official ambulance of your Laredo Lemurs.
Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Catholic College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Kaplan College. Call 800-617-0800. Right now.
All right, for Sioux City, it's going to be Maddie Johnson leading things off. So we go back up to the top of the order here in the bottom of the fourth inning. It's 5-0 Laredo, and up there on the mound for the Laredo Lemurs is Matt Lucen. So Lucen going to look to hold down Sioux City once again here through this half inning. Here's the pitch. Fastball away. So it's Maddie Johnson, Michael Lang, and then Noah Pereiro coming up to the plate for Sioux City. And the pitch. High for a ball. Let's go ahead and get you the scoreboard from around the American Association. I feel the need to bring you up to date on what's going on in the rest of the league. Two balls and no strikes. And the pitch. Inside for a ball. In the top of the eighth inning, Kansas City all over Lincoln right now. Kansas City's up 10-0, and of course they're paying attention to that game here. Sioux City is up in the division over the Kansas City T-Bones, but the Kansas City T-Bones playing good baseball, and they're starting to come on strong as the next pitch is in there for a strike to Matty Johnson. Sioux City starts the day 6.5 games up over the Kansas City T-Bones. Well, you might say that's a pretty big lead. Yeah, it is. The 3-1 pitch, and that one is high, ball four. So a four-pitch walk to Matty Johnson. That's the second time tonight he's walked. He's the only base runner so far tonight for Sioux City. 5-0 Laredo. So Kansas City up 10-0 over Lincoln. Winnipeg has put one in the books already over Gary. It's a 10-0 final there. Yeah, they started at 6:06 p.m. in the Central Time Zone. The game took 2 hours and 14 minutes, and Winnipeg put up 10 runs. That game was lickety-split. Take a look at the box score on that one. Here's the first pitch to the new batter, Michael Lang, and it misses outside. And now Luke Bailey's going to get out from behind home plate and go talk things over with the starting pitcher, Matt Lucen. Yeah, Hernandez from Winnipeg ended up pitching 9 complete innings. He gave up 6 hits, did not allow a run. He only walked 1 batter and struck out 5. Only 3 pitchers in the whole ballgame were used, so 2 by Gary and 1 by Winnipeg. And now Mike Meyer's going to come out of the dugout as well and join in on the conversation with Matt Lucen and Luke Bailey. So we'll finish up the scoreboard for you. St. Paul and Sioux Falls are playing baseball. They're in the top of the seventh inning. St. Paul's up 9-4. And the Joplin Blasters are up over the Amarillo Thunderheads right now, 7-6. They're in the bottom of the fifth inning. Wichita and Grand Prairie knotted up at 2 apiece. And Fargo and Sussex County, they were playing baseball, but it's currently delayed due to rain. Fargo's up 5-2 in the game. It doesn't tell me exactly what inning they're in. Let's see if I can try to get that information. One ball and no strikes to the right fielder, Michael Lang, a very good right fielder, not only out in the field, but also with his bat. Here's the pitch, a curveball to Lang, and that gets over the plate for a strike. Evens up the count at one ball and one strike. So Maddie Johnson over there at first base. He was caught stealing back in the first inning. That was one of the outs made there that inning. Luke Bailey put the ball right on the money at second base to get the out. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Curveball swung on. One hop right back to Lucen. He'll turn to second for one. Medeiros has to leap in the air to bring it down. And he's able to do so, and they only get one out. So that erases Maddie Johnson off of the base pass, but that leaves a very speedy Michael Lang over there at first base. So the Lemurs get the 1-6 put out at second, but Michael Lang reaches on the fielder's choice. Coming up to the plate now is Noah Perillo. So Perillo bats from the left side, taking a look at his baseball bat before he steps into the batter's box. So Michael Lang over there at first base. Lang on the year with 28 ridiculous stolen bases. The pitch. Strike on the outside corner. And Lang has only been caught three times so far this season. So pretty good numbers for Michael Lang trying to steal bags. He currently leads the league in that category. And a quick toss over to first base. And Lucen scares Lang back into the bag. Perillo flew out to right, or excuse me, out to center field in his last at bat. Now Lucen out of the stretch. He'll come set. He kicks and throws home on the 0-1. That one's lined into right field. That's going to be a base hit. And going up to second base is Michael Lang. And in with the first single of the ball game for Sioux City is Noah Perillo. So he's got the first hit for the Sioux City Explorers. It took him to the fourth inning to get it. 5-0 Laredo. Here comes Ryan Court to the plate. So Lang up to second base, Perillo in to first. Well, Perillo could steal a base as well. He's got 12 on the year, so I don't know. Will we see a double steal here? I doubt it with the Sioux City Ball Club being down 5 runs. They have to be a little bit more conservative. They don't want to be thrown out on the base pass if they don't have to be. Here's the pitch. Outside, and of course with the number 4 hitter up, you got to let him do his job. Ryan Court starting the day batting 327. He's got 66 hits on the season. He struck out in his last at bat. So Matt Lucen holds the ball behind his back. He looks in to get the signs. And he'll set at the belt and deliver. Breaking ball, swung and a miss. A snap throw down to first base, and they got him out. Perillo tried to dance back in. He stutter-stepped a few times, and Geiger swiped once and missed, and then came back with a second swipe and was able to get him. So a pickoff play over at first base, and it's successful for the Laredo Lemurs. It goes 2-3 on the pickoff, and that'll create the second out. So a nice little backdoor throw there by Luke Bailey, and Dustin Geiger sneaking in behind the runner Perillo. So one ball and one strike to Ryan Court. Now a runner at second base and two down. Lemurs up by 5. Now a flash play over at second base. And Lang back in safely at second as Kevin Taylor was sneaking in behind the runner. Well, wouldn't that have been something without even a pitch being thrown? They could have got two outs. One ball, one strike. And the pitch. Breaking ball called a strike on the inside corner. That's going to make it a 1-2 count. Lucen stands right in the middle of the rubber out there on the hill. He cradles the mitt next to his chest, holds the ball behind his back, and looks underneath that black and gold cap. He'll throw on the 1-2. High for a ball. That'll even up the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Five runs for the Lemurs in the ball game. They picked up a run back in the first, 2 in the second, 2 more in the fourth inning. Tommy Mendoza is on deck for Sioux City. The 2-2 pitch. Breaking ball swung on and fell back into the screen. That was a big curveball thrown up there by Matt Lucen. Another pitch coming up. So once again, it's two balls and two strikes. So Matt Lucen, ready to go. Waving the bat over the plate is Ryan Court. And the 2-2 pitch in the dirt, blocked by Bailey. It'll move over to his right. And we'll see a full count pitch coming up now to Ryan Court. Ryan Court was drafted in the 23rd round by the Arizona Diamondbacks at Illinois State University. That's in Normal, Illinois. That's where the Normal Corn Builders play. Not an easy name to say. The Normal Corn Builders. Got to really concentrate on that one. Three balls and two strikes. Here it comes. The runner goes. The pitch is outside. The throw down to third base is off the tip of the glove of Silverio. It's going to roll down the left field line. And coming in to score is Michael Lang. So he steals second. And it's going to be an E2. Stolen base E2 to score the run. So Lang steals a base and then comes home on the error by the catcher on the throw. And Ryan Court on the play ends up earning a walk. So a double dip there for the Sioux City Explorers. They get a run and a runner goes over to first base. Now into the batter's box is Tommy Mendoza. 5-1 Lemurs here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Here's the pitch. High for a bomb. One ball and no strikes to Mendoza. And the pitch. Breaking ball. That's a curve. That is in there for a strike at the knees. One ball and one strike. 5 runs on 9 hits for the Lemurs. 1 run on 1 hit now for Sioux City. Lucen's ready to go. The pitch. Breaking ball swung on and lined into right field. That'll be a base hit for Tommy Mendoza. On top of the ball is Phipps, and pulling into second base is Ryan Court. So after the walk, there's a single by Mendoza, and now the Lemurs are getting guys moving. So the bullpen is going to get going now for Laredo. And Luke Bailey out to talk things over real quick. The Lemurs have already had Mike Meyer go out to the mound so far in this inning. But after that base hit, somebody's going to get up and start throwing. You can see a bunch of guys starting to move around in the bullpen after that last base hit. They frantically got up and started warming their arms up, started warming the legs up too. Here's Matt Coach coming up to the plate. So runners at first and second base and two down. And Matt Coach digging in. Right-handed batter is Matt Coach. Matt Coach in his last at bat flew out to center field. So over there at second base is Ryan Court. Tommy Mendoza is at first, and a snap throw down to second base. It gets away from the second baseman, Taylor. Everybody's going to move up a base, and that's going to put runners at second and third. So the Lemurs with another error in the inning. That's going to be an E2 on Luke Bailey to allow the runners to move up. So Ryan Court to third, Tommy Mendoza over to second base. Lemurs trying to backdoor Ryan Court over there at second. One ball and no strikes. So Bailey has thrown away two balls here this inning. One that has helped the Sioux City Explorers score run, and who knows what's going to happen next. Here's the pitch. Breaking ball. That finds its way over the plate. One ball and one strike. So runners at second and third for Sioux City. Well, those are tough errors to go against the catchers. You know, they're trying to make throws, trying to help the team get out of innings. Trying to get outs. The 1-1 pitch swung and a foul ball back to the screen. Luke Bailey had the right idea there. And the runner, Ryan Court, was off the bag pretty far, but the throw would have been on the money. The Lemurs probably would have been able to get Court out. So good thought initially, but unfortunately the throw went a little bit to the right of the second baseman, Kevin Taylor. Lucen throws the 1-2 pitch, and that one's low and outside. Two balls and two strikes. The Lemurs are up by four runs, and now the shortstop, Medeiros, comes in and kicks some dirt around. As he was, thought he was going to head towards the mound. But that would have been funny for a rookie to go up there and start talking to Matt Lucen. Usually you don't see rookies make that move. Two balls and two strikes. The pitch. Curveball swung on and fouled back into the fence. So a lot of breaking balls being thrown up there right now by Matt Lucen, and maybe his fastball is just a little bit too flat. Maybe he doesn't have a whole lot on it, so he's using a lot of the breaking balls. But the Lemurs do have bullpen action right now. Only one person up and throwing, and really can't tell who it is from the distance that we're at right now. It is a right-handed thrower. Runners at second and third for Sioux City. This can turn into a big inning for them, but there are two down. No wind blowing right now here at the ballpark. The flags lie limp out there in right center field. The 2-2 swung on and tipped into the glove of Bailey. He holds on, and that's going to be strike three. But Sioux City strikes here. They come up with one run on one hit. There were two errors and two left. We're going to the top of the fifth inning. Lemurs up 5-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Today at Whataburger, we're cooking the Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. The chicken is hot and fresh. It's got melted Monterey Jack cheese topped with lettuce, tomato, bacon, and then the honey mustard adds a nice sweet flavor to it.
All the flavors come together just perfect. I mean, not only do I want to eat it, but I keep wanting to look at it.
The crunchiness of the bacon adds a really nice texture.
Honey mustard and chicken just go together. You know, sweet and savory, it's a perfect mix.
Try the new Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. Only at Whataburger for a limited time.
Hey Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at LaredoLemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark. Texas Inflatable Rentals has Laredo's largest water slides. We are proud to say that we serve the greater Laredo area and supply slip sliding fun for kids of all ages. Texas Inflatable Rentals has a huge selection of inflatables for every budget. And to add to the party, we rent tables, chairs, snow cone machines, popcorn machines, and cotton candy machines that will help take your party to the next level. We also have moonwalks and bounce houses. Contact Texas Inflatable Rentals at 956-436-3909 or at TexasInflatableRentals.com. And book with the coupon code LEMURS for a 10% discount. That's Texas Inflatable Reynolds, Laredo's largest water slide.
Driscoll Health Plan loads the bases with value. We knock it out of the park with all the value-added services we bring to our Medicaid members. Driscoll families cheer on the Grand Slam packages, sports physicals, free memberships to Boys and Girls Clubs, and dental care for pregnant women over 21. Take a swing at our baby showers offered by Cadena de Madre. Forget those peanuts and Cracker Jacks, root for our baby blankets and more. Come slide into home when you receive gift cards for completing Texas Health Steps checkups and attending postpartum visits on time. Don't miss a play. Restrictions and limits may apply. Visit DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Leading off the fifth inning for Laredo, number 55, Dennis Phipps.
All right, here we go. In the top of the fifth inning, Dennis Phipps is going to lead it off for the Laredo Lemurs. It's 5-1 Laredo. Staying up on the mound is Anthony Ferrara for the Sioux City Explorers. Ferrara throws, and the fastball misses outside. So for the Lemurs, it's 5 runs on 9 hits. They have 2 errors. Both of those errors coming there in the bottom of the fourth inning. Both errors by Luke Bailey on a couple of throws. Here's the 1-0 pitch. That one is high for a ball. 2 balls and no strikes. Bailey was trying to catch one guy stealing over at third base, and the ball ended up getting by Juan Silverio. And the other error came when he was trying to pick Ryan Kordoff at second base. Says swinging and missing is Dennis Phipps. 2 balls and 1 strike. Two balls and one strike. Get to the big league scoreboard here as a lot of games in the books already in the majors. Some current big league action going on, though. Two balls and one strike. Here's the pitch. Changeup. Call the strike on the outside part of the plate. Baltimore is up over Detroit, 3-0 in the top of the ninth inning. The Cubbies 2, the Atlanta Braves nothing. And there was a no-hit bid there by John Lester. But it ends up getting broken up. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Inside, that'll make it ball 3 to Phipps. Phipps 0-for-1 in the ball game so far. And got to give you a note on Dennis Phipps as he's up there at the batter's box right now. During this series, he's been absolutely ridiculous. Here comes the 3-2. And that one swung in and a ground ball foul up the third baseline. Phipps coming into the game had reached base in 9 straight at-bats from Wednesday through yesterday, including 4 walks, 4 singles, and a home run. It ended when he hit into a double play in the 4th inning yesterday of the second game. So not the continuation game, but the regular scheduled game that only ended up going 5 innings because the rain came in and washed the rest of it out. 3 balls and 2 strikes. The pitch swung on and fouled away. So the Cubs are up 2-0 over Atlanta, and the no-hit bid is gone. Atlanta has 2 hits now. Cleveland 9, Cincinnati 1. They're in the bottom of the 8th inning. In the top of the 7th, the Milwaukee Brewers are up 7-4 over Pittsburgh. The Rangers and the Astros playing ball. It's the Rangers 5, the Astros 2. Here comes the 3-2 pitch to Phipps. The kick, the throw home, and that one is low, ball 4. Phipps will take his walk. And he'll head down to first base, and that'll bring up Juan Silverio. St. Louis is up over the New York Mets, 8-2. They're in the middle of the 8th inning. And in the top of the 5th, the San Francisco Giants are leading Arizona 7-1. Rockies 1, Padres 1. They're in the middle of the 5th inning. And the Boston Red Sox and the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim, they have no score in the bottom of the 2nd. Runner at first base, and nobody out for the Laredo Lemurs. 5-1 Laredo. Toss over to first base, and Phipps jogs back in easily. Twins and A's in the bottom of the 3rd inning, no score. And the Mariners are up 4-3 over the New York Yankees. They're playing in New York. Actually, that game is over. It's a final. So Seattle wins 4-3 over the Yankees. The rest of these will be finals for you. The pitch, high for a ball. Tampa Bay over Toronto today, 3-2. And the Washington Nationals beat the Los Angeles Dodgers. Actually, they had to finish off one game from yesterday. The 5-3 final was Washington beating Los Angeles in the completion game from yesterday. The game got suspended because the lights kept going out in Washington. From what I understand, they ended up going out 3 times before they actually called the game off. The 1-0. Swung in on a ground ball. One hopper right back to Ferrara at the mound. He'll throw to second base for 1. Back over to first, and that's a double play. So that's going to erase the Lemurs off of the base paths. And that'll create 2 outs. So 2 down quickly, and Kevin Taylor will be the batter for the Laredo Lemurs. Yeah, so the Nationals won the completion game from yesterday 5-3, and the Dodgers win the regular game behind Clayton Kershaw. Dodgers win that one 4-2. Pfister ends up taking the loss in that one, and Bryce Harper hit his 27th home run of the season. The pitch. Kevin Taylor sees a strike on the outside part of the plate, a fastball. And the Philadelphia Phillies beat the Miami Marlins 3-1. So there's your big league scoreboard. And it's no balls and 1 strike to Kevin Taylor. The pitch is low. So I was mentioning that no-hit bid by John Lester. And the scoreboard registered a hit in the Atlanta first inning when Nick Markakis reached on an infield single. But in the 7th, it was changed to an error by the Cubs rookie third baseman Chris Bryant, which meant John Lester had a no-hitter through 6 innings. And that's kind of odd. With 2 outs in the Atlanta first, Markakis hit a ball that scooted past Bryant at third, as here's a pitch that misses high to Kevin Taylor. The official scorekeeper, Jack Wilkerson, called it a single, but in the top of the 7th announced that the call had been changed to an error. So with 2 outs in the Atlanta first, Markakis hit a ball that scooted past Bryant, and The official scorekeeper called it a hit initially and then turned it into an error. Here's a long drive off the bat of Kevin Taylor. Ranging for it is Johnson out there into right center field. He'll get underneath it and make the catch, and the Lemurs are retired here in the fifth. We're through 4.5. We're going to the bottom of the fifth inning. It's 5-1 Laredo. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. Looking to travel this summer? If the year-round flights to Las Vegas aren't fit for you, take advantage of Allegiant's direct flights from Laredo International Airport to Orlando. For as low as $119 round trip, you and your family can be in Orlando in 2.5 hours. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. Texas Outlaw Grill is a proud sponsor of your Laredo Lemurs, specializing in outlaw delicacies such as the Texican, the Gringo, and the Bandit Hot Dog and their ever-famous barbecue burger. Be the first to try their groundbreaking Cabarito Hamburger and Cabarito Hot Dog. For all to-go orders, catering, and fundraising information, go by 5209 Springfield Suite No. 4 or call 956-771-1919. That's Texas Outlaw Grill.
Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic, the official team doctors of your Laredo Lemurs. Now with two convenient locations to better serve you. Our north location is located at 9652 McPherson Road, Suite 12. Our south location is located at 5102 State Highway 359. Laredo Sports Medicine offers an array of services from physical therapy to our newest service, orthopedic surgery. Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic is changing orthopedic care one athlete at a time. Visit our website at laredosportsmed.com for more information.
This summer, Allegiant will increase to 4 weekly flights to Las Vegas, Nevada. If gambling in Vegas isn't your thing, Allegiant is also increasing to 2 weekly flights to Orlando. Enjoy the Disney theme parks, Legoland, Universal Studios, SeaWorld, and the Kennedy Space Center. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. All right, so go to the bottom of the fifth inning, and Matt Lucen stays on the mound for the Laredo Lemurs. Remember, at the bottom of the fourth inning, Lucen was struggling a little bit, and the Lemurs started getting some guys going down in the bullpen. Well, he was able to work out of the inning after striking out Matt Coach and leaving runners at second and third base for Sioux City. So there's still some bullpen action for the Lemurs, guys up there moving around, but nobody actually throwing right now. 5-1 Laredo, and Eno Patron coming up to the plate now for the Sioux City Explorers. Lucen will fire away, and there's a ground ball on one pitch over to Medeiros. He'll bobble it. It's between his legs. He recovers. He throws to first, and it's in time to get the out. The Laredo Lemurs pull a rabbit out of their hat right there as Medeiros bobbled the ball several times at short, and Patron just could not beat it out. Now the first base coach, and he's in an argument with the first base umpire, Sean Hicks, and now here comes the manager, Steve Montgomery, to talk over this one. So 6-3 put out in the scorebook for the first out in the inning, and that comes on one pitch to Eno Patron. 5-1 Laredo, and the fans here are not happy. The manager is not happy. The first base coach not happy. There's a lot of unhappy people here in Sioux City right now. But Medeiros picked that ball up and quickly fired it with all of his strength over to first base. I don't think I've seen him throw a ball so hard. Montgomery trying to explain his situation over there at first base as they play carnival music here. We've seen a couple of carnivals throughout Sioux City over the weekend. There's a lot of people in town, and we'll tell you why here. When we get some downtime, we'll bring that up. There's a tease for you right there. Exciting, right? So Eno Patron, by the way, with 4 hits in the series. And he ends up grounding out there. So into the batter's box is Dylan Usiak. Usiak with a strikeout in his last at bat. Here's the pitch. That's a strike in the outside corner. Well, the Lemurs would love to get Matt Lucen through the fifth inning here. Want to make sure he qualifies for the victory. If the Lemurs would have took him out in the last half inning, he would not even qualify for the win. Here's the 0-1. Swung in on a ground ball up the first baseline. Foul. No balls and 2 strikes. Now Luke Bailey's going to hand deliver the new baseball over to Matt Lucen. Left-handed batter, Usiak in the batter's box. Usiak starting the day batting 233. He's in his third season of pro baseball, and all of them spend in the independent leagues. He's in his second year with Sioux City. No balls and two strikes. And the pitch. Swung on and a foul ball off to the left. Usiak played junior college baseball at Modesto Junior College before attending Chico State. Chico State, an NCAA Division II school. That's north of Sacramento. The 0-2 pitch, and there's a swing and a miss. I almost said the no-2 pitch. Might have been appropriate as well, though. Usiak strikes out for the second time, and here comes Tim Colwell. So the number 9 batter coming up to the plate. So Colwell digging in. He flew out to left field in his last at bat. Lemurs up 5-1. We're in the bottom of the fifth inning. And Matt Lucen throws home, and that is a fastball that misses low. Working underneath some partly cloudy skies right now. When we started the ball game, it was clear. We're hoping the rain stays away. We've had a lot of rain here in this series. One ball and no strikes. A lot of wind as well. There's no wind right now. The 1-0. High for a ball. Not that I'm calling upon it by any means. Not asking it to come around. Two balls and no strikes. So Lucen will work quickly. He'll throw again. That one is swung on and fouled away off to the left. Two balls and one strike. 9 hits for the Lemurs, 2 hits for Sioux City. Sioux City got their lone run in the ball game in the fourth inning. In the bottom of the fourth, the Lemurs picked up a run in the first, 2 in the second, and 2 more in the fourth inning. The 2-1 pitch, swung in and a ground ball up the middle, ranging for it, Medeiros. It's going to get by everybody and go into center field. So a 2-at-base hit by Tim Colwell. And still nobody throwing for the Laredo Lemurs, so it looks like Matt Lucen will be given a little bit more leeway here to try to get through this inning. The way things got up and going, though, in that last half inning, it looked like they might not let him go too much longer. But if he settles in here and starts getting right back on track, I'm sure manager Pete Gavilla will let him go as long as possible. A 4-run difference in the ball game right now, and we go up to the top of the order for Maddie Johnson, who's been a thorn in the side of the Laredo Lemurs. Maddie Johnson with 2 walks so far in this ballgame. Here's the pitch. Swung on and a ground ball foul up the third baseline. Maddie Johnson, the center fielder. And Maddie Johnson in this series has picked up 3 base hits, and he has 3 walks to his credit throughout the series. No balls and 1 strike. He has scored 3 times coming into this ballgame as well. The 0-1 pitch, breaking ball, stays high. Maddie Johnson, the 2015 season, will mark his first season as a member of the Sioux City Explorers. After not being drafted out of Bellevue University in nearby Bellevue, Johnson began his professional career with the Gateway Grizzlies back in 2010 in the Frontier League. The 1-1 swung on and missed. 1 ball and 2 strikes. When he was with the Grizzlies, he stepped right in and had a huge impact offensively for the squad. In 47 games, he hit .313 with 57 hits and 3 triples. He also had 24 stolen bases. 1 ball and 2 strikes. Johnson's big start caught the eye of the Boston Red Sox, who signed him back on September 30th of 2010. Here's the 1-2, swung on and tipped in and out of the glove of Luke Bailey. Johnson was promoted to the Red Sox South Atlantic League affiliate for the finale of the 28 games of the 2011 season. And he continued to impress with adding another 26 hits and 4 stolen bases to finish off the 2011 season before picking up a .307 batting average with 19 stolen bases. 1 ball and 2 strikes, 2 outs. The runner goes from first. The pitch is swung on and fouled away. So we'll do it all over again. So Colwell will go back to first base, and we'll have a 1-2 pitch coming up. Maddie Johnson remained with the Red Sox for the next 3 years, from 2012 through 2014, and he reached up to AAA. He spent the entire 2014 season with the Salem Red Sox of the Carolina League. That's high A ball. 1 ball and 2 strikes. And the pitch. Swung in a line drive up the middle, a base hit right to the head of the starter Matt Lucen. So back-to-back base hits with 2 down. And now the bullpen's going to be getting going again. They'll fire it up one more time. Now coming out of the bullpen for the Laredo Lemurs is the pitching coach, Mike Meyer. So another visit to the mound here. The Lemurs are up 5-1. Matt Lucen needs to get one more out to at least to qualify for a victory in this ball game. Every now and then, though, the Sioux City Explorers are hitting them around. Sioux City picked up two hits in the fourth inning, and there were two batters walked that inning. After two outs are made here in the fifth inning, they have picked up two hits. Coming up to the plate is the very tough hitting Michael Lang. Michael Lang all over the leaderboard in the American Association. Just look at this guy's number. He's the league leader in stolen bases. He's also one of the guys tops in the league in batting. He's got a .353 batting average. He's currently third in the league in that category. So this guy's a good hitter. Good little ball player. And the pinch. Swung on and missed. A fastball in the outside corner. Nice pitch there. Michael Lang has 40 RBIs. He's currently fourth in the league in that category. He's second in the league at at-bats. No balls and one strike. Does anybody really care about that stat, though, the at-bat stat? The 0-1. Swung on and missed. That just means you get up to the plate a lot. So two strikes. No balls and two strikes, so two outs. Runners at first and second base for Sioux City. It's a 5-1 game. Lemurs are in the lead. Michael Lang leads the league in run scored. I know the league cares about that stat. You should care about the run scored stat. That's how people win and lose ball games. No balls and two strikes. Now Lang's going to step out of the batter's box. He was just about to get comfortable and decided, meh, not a good time to be in here. I'm stepping out. Now he's going to step out again. He's pretty close to the plate. And it's no balls and two strikes to Michael Lang. And the pitch. And a check swing. He went around. That's going to do it for Michael Lang and the Sioux City Explorers as Lang spikes his bat into the ground in frustration. It's 5-1 Laredo. We're going to head to the top of the sixth inning. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E, that's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's got to be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Do you want to sit in a car for 7 hours, risk a flat tire, traffic, or highway construction delays? Fly direct from Laredo International Airport to Dallas-Fort Worth on American Airlines. From Dallas, you can change planes and take a flight to Tokyo, London, or even Rio de Janeiro. With 4 daily arrivals and departures, American Airlines is sure to have a connection that works best for you. So avoid spending hours in the car or risk an accident on the highway or even a flat tire. Fly in comfort from Laredo International Airport. Visit AA.com for details and to book a reservation.
Uni-Trade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Uni-Trade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Uni-Trade.
There's a reason why Popeyes creates some of the best-tasting chicken in the world. We were born in New Orleans, Louisiana, the land of good fun and great cooking. Spicy flavor is a way of life in New Orleans, and everything we make reflects it. From our Popeyes bona fide chicken and handcrafted tenders to our home-style mashed potatoes with Cajun gravy and our soft, buttery biscuits, everything we make is made with care and served up fresh. Only at Popeyes.
All right, here we go into the top of the sixth inning. Lemurs up 5-1 in the ball game, and for Laredo, it's going to be Jared Medeiros, Luke Bailey, and Jeudy Valdez coming up to the plate. These guys have done some damage so far for the Laredo Lemurs. There's three hits amongst the bottom three guys and three runs scored for the Laredo Lemurs here in this ballgame. 5-1 Laredo, and back up on the mound is Anthony Ferrara. So we go to the top of the sixth. And Ferrara will throw home, and that one is in the dirt, and it came up on the catcher a little bit, so he turns back and gets a new baseball. One ball and no strikes. Madero's having a good night. He's picked up a couple of hits, and he has scored a couple of runs for the Laredo Lemurs. And the right-handed batter sees a pitch. It swung on and hit on a line into right field. Off the end of the bat, it's going to drop in there for his third hit of the ballgame. Madero's having his best night as a professional, picking up his third hit in the ballgame. He has not done that yet for the Laredo Lemurs. This is the first time he's picked up three hits as a professional. So congratulations to Jared Madero's. He's had a lot of games where he's picked up one hit. And that's going to help raise his batting average over 200 for the first time. So Jared Madero's starting to get the feeling, starting to get the vibe of the American Association. So Luke Bailey into the batter's box now for Laredo. He shows bunt. Bunt's at the ball, kind of with a jab at it. And it ends up rolling foul. Lemurs up by four. Luke Bailey starting the day batting 212 for the Laredo Lemurs. Luke Bailey on the season with 8 home runs. No balls and one strike. Luke Bailey laid down a sack bunt back in the second inning, and he flew out to center field in the fourth. Medeiros over there at first base with nobody out. Ferrara, he'll set. The lefty will throw over to first base, and over back in is Medeiros. So for the Laredo Lemurs, when they picked up that run back in the first, Ty Morrison singled. He ended up stealing second base, and he was driven in after he got to third base by Dennis Phipps. Phipps with a sack fly to right field to drive home the run. The 0-1 pitch swung on, a high fly ball to left. This one's put well in the air. Colwell has no idea where it's at. Now he'll catch up to it. No, he won't. The ball's going to land, and it'll land about 5 feet short of the warning track. Going to third base is Medeiros. Heading to second base is Luke Bailey. Colwell, right off the bat, had no idea where it was. Then it looked like he had an eyeball on it and then lost it again, and the ball ends up falling to the ground, and that's going to be a double for Luke Bailey. Well, the Lemurs had problems around this time of night last night with a mix of gray clouds, blue skies, well, purple skies right now, and the lights trying to take over. All that mix ends up turning into a tough sky for anybody out there. And the ball was just lost by the left fielder, Colwell. So that's going to bring up Jeudy Valdez. Valdez with a big triple in his last at bat. He ended up picking up an RBI, driving in Jared Medeiros. 5-1 Laredo, and the Lemurs threatening again here with runners at second and third. We're in the sixth inning. Infield playing in for Sioux City. The pitch, swung and a missed, a changeup. No balls and one strike to Jeudy. Jeudy in his first at bat, he struck out. Eleven hits tonight for the Laredo Lemurs. Lemurs picked up 2 runs in the second when Kevin Taylor and Jared Medeiros led off with singles, and they were bunted over by Luke Bailey to second and third, and then Jeudy Valdez struck out. A walk later to Ty Morrison, and then a single by Devontre Richardson that drove in the 2 runs. At the time, the Lemurs took a 3-0 lead. No balls and one strike. And the 0-1 delivery, swung in a line drive, hit well into left field. That ball is going to fall. It's going to roll all the way out to the wall. Medeiros is going to score. Right behind Medeiros is Bailey. He scores a run, and the Lemurs are up 7-1. Hitting the ball tonight are the Laredo Lemurs. So Jeudy Valdez now with a double and a triple on the day, and he picks up his third RBI. So heading up to the mound is the catcher coach. And he's going to talk things over with the relief pitcher, Anthony Ferrara, and bullpen action for Sioux City. And Ty Morrison coming up to the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. So the Lemurs turning it over, and the big sticks are going to come out. Now the Lemurs well within striking distance of the American Association lead, and if they can start getting their bats going like this on a nightly basis, they can be a lot of trouble. The pitching staff has settled in, and they're looking good. They have the third best ERA in the American Association. The pitch, bunt shown, pulled back, and that one misses low. But a lot of people around the American Association think that the Lemurs have the best hitting team just by looking at this lineup. They're currently second in the league in home runs, but they have dropped down in the average category. Dropped down to eighth in the league in that category, and that's something they need to get up, get the base hits up. Well, they're doing it here tonight. Here's the 1-0. Bunt shown and bunted out, and it's missed. One ball and one strike. 12 hits tonight for Laredo. They picked up 17 hits the other night, and last night they just kind of scuffled, ended up not getting any runs, even though they only played five because the rain came and they ended up getting washed out. Lemurs only picked up two hits in last night's ball game. Here comes the 1-1 pitch from Ferrara. Bunt shown again, and it's bunted out up the third baseline, grabbing at Mendoza. Mendoza will throw over to first base to get the out. Jeudy Valdez on the play moves up to third base, and the Lemurs have a runner at third and nobody out. And that sack bunt laid down by Ty Morrison. Kind of surprised to see Morrison laying down a bunt there. He's been so hot with the bat. And the Lemurs with a comfortable lead. I mean, Sioux City can't explode. They are a good team. They can put a lot of runs up on the board. But I would personally let Ty Morrison swing the bat there. I don't know if he had bunt on his mind all by himself or if the Laredo Lemurs put the sign on. Here's Devontre Richardson. And now a break for a meeting at the mound. Steve Montgomery heading out to the mound. And we'll see if we have a pitching change here. So Montgomery talking things over. Seeing how guys are doing. Wants to check in with his fellas. Now the home plate umpire will come out from behind home plate and try to break up the conversation with all those guys out there. So they are going to go to the bullpen. Montgomery was waiting until the umpire got up there to make the move, so he was just kind of wasting some time. New pitcher on the mound. We'll take a break. The Lemurs have two runs here in the inning. We're in the top of the sixth, and Laredo's up 7-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Falcon Bank and the Laredo Lemurs are a winning combination. At Falcon, they know what counts. Personalized service, attention to detail, and genuine commitment to helping customers achieve their dreams. Falcon Bank, guided by faith, grounded by family, and committed to you.
Need a little spark in your life? Then come on out to Uni-Trade Stadium for Friday Night Fireworks. Tickets start as low as $5, and you'll get to see great baseball and great fireworks all in one night. To get tickets, call 956-7-LEMURS or go online at laredolemurs.com. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas, as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. And the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn, Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo.
All right, so a new pitcher in is Jimmer Kennedy. Anthony Ferrara is done. He was the second pitcher of the ball game for the Sioux City Explorers. Lemurs are up 7-1 in this one. And there's one out in the inning as we sit in the top of the sixth inning. Runner at third base for the Laredo Lemurs and the infield playing in for Sioux City. So Devontre Richardson into the batter's box now for Laredo. Jeudy Valdez over there at third base and one out. And working out of the stretch is Kennedy. He'll throw home on a breaking ball, misses high. Jimmer Kennedy thrown in his 19th game of the season. He's 1-0 on the year with a 3.19 ERA. He has two saves and has thrown in 31 innings with 34 strikeouts, 10 walks, and 23 hits given up so far this year. And the 1-0 pitch. Swung on and a pop foul right behind us. Kennedy this year has given up 11 runs. All of them have been earned through those 31 innings of work. The Lemurs trying to get another run right now. Judy Valdez at third base, but that run belongs to Anthony Ferrara. One ball and one strike. And the pitch home. Breaking ball, a curve that falls into the strike zone. Jimmer Kennedy currently in his sixth season of professional baseball. He's played in independent ball the whole time. Before joining Sioux City in 2013, he made stops in Brockton. He played with Sussex County and the New Jersey Jackals, all of the Can-Am League, and he also spent some time with the Fort Worth Cats and the American Association back when they were in the American Association. The 1-2 swung on a ground ball over to the left side. It takes a wild hop. Perillo grabs it, throws over to first base, and it's in time to get the runner, Devontre Richardson. Two down there. Lemurs still up by six. Perillo was backing up Mendoza. Mendoza jumped in front of him, and the ball took some kind of weird hop off the grass. Perillo was able to grab it and fire across to first base. And now Dustin Geiger coming up into the batter's box with two down. So Judy Valdez on the play ends up staying at third base. Geiger with a base hit back in the first. He popped out into foul territory in the second and hit into a double play in the fourth. Here's the pitch home. Swung on and a long drive to left. This one's hit well. Is it going to be fair or foul? It's going to be a fair ball and a home run for Dustin Geiger. Two more runs up on the board for the Laredo Lemurs. Geiger with home run number 11 on the season. And he'll round the bases. That's his fourth home run in a Lemurs uniform. Ball went right down the left field line. It hit off the foul pole and pinged over to the left. And the Laredo Lemurs strike big here in the sixth inning for four runs. It's now 9-1 Laredo. And here's Dennis Phipps. Well, Dennis Phipps can do the same thing. Here's the pitch to Phipps. A fastball low. And Geiger picks up RBI, number 36 and 37 for his overall season, number 8 and 9 with the Laredo Lemurs. He's got a lot of power, and he unleashed right there. One ball and no strikes. The pitch to Phipps. A strike on the outside part of the plate. One ball and one strike. So 1-1 count to Phipps. Phipps on the day without a base hit. Kind of odd. The 1-1. Swung in and a fly ball. Hit high in the air into right center field. Johnson calling for it. He's putting his arms out saying, I got this one. And he does indeed as he drifts off over to his left. And that'll be the final out here in the inning. But the Lemurs strike big. They come up with four runs on four hits. There were three extra base hits in the inning. There were no errors and nobody left. We're going to the bottom of the sixth inning. 9-1 Laredo.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined. And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
Breakfast speaks for itself here at Whataburger. It's going to be hot, it's going to be fresh.
It's almost like when you were a kid and you wake up in the morning, you can smell mom cooking breakfast.
I like their hash browns.
My favorite is the honey butter chicken biscuit. I like the taquitos.
We have some fresh cracked eggs here.
I like these pancakes because they're fluffy.
I really like the fact that you can get into Whataburger real fast and bring it on the go.
We're cooking breakfast for you at Whataburger.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready.
That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you.
Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epic or chest bumps, touchdown dancing, breakdancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain Cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Hey, ¿tienes algo que celebrar? ¿Que le salió el primer diente a tu hijo? ¿Que tu abuelita aprendió a tuitear? ¿Que cambiaste tu cheque? La respuesta es la misma. Pues un carnesazo. No importa lo que estés celebrando, lo que importa es que lo celebres. Pues con un carnesazo de HEB. En HEB encuentras gran variedad de cortes a precios bajos y de buena calidad. Carnesazo. Carne asada con ganas. Solo en HEB.
We'd like. All right, coming up to the plate now for the Sioux City Explorers is Noah Perillo. He's 1-for-2 on the day, and the Lemurs have a new pitcher. It's B.J. Hyatt taking over on the mound. The Lemurs are up 9-1. Matt Lucent lasted long enough to qualify for the victory in this ball game, with the Lemurs up 8, the pinch. Perillo sees that one Mitch high. So Hyatt on the season, a 2-0 record and a mighty .87 ERA, so he's been looking good for the Laredo Lemurs this year. He has pitched in 21 games for Laredo, and he last pitched against Amarillo on July 13th, so he's well rested out there on the hill. The 1-0 pitch, and that one is high for a ball. Hyatt has not given up a run in five outings. That's over 6 2/3 innings. So he's been stellar for the Laredo Lemurs, and you just look at his ERA, .87. That's really low. Two balls and no strikes, though, to Perillo. The pitch swung on and fouled back into the fence. 9-1 Lemurs. So the Lemurs in here to Sioux City on an exciting weekend. A lot of stuff going on, and we're staying in a downtown hotel, even though we've checked out now since we're hitting the road after this ball game. But there's an event in town that's been pretty big, and you see a lot of bicycles running around the downtown Sioux City area and around the river. The 2-1 pitch swung on and a pop-up over to the left side. Silverio into foul territory, and it'll be Silverio making the catch in foul territory. So one down and Ryan Court the next batter. Yeah, the event is called RAGBRAY, and it's an acronym and a registered trademark for the Register's annual Great Bicycle Ride across Iowa. So it's pretty interesting, just tons and tons of people on bicycles filing into the city over the last couple of days, and they're really starting to set up today. We saw a lot of motorhomes in the area, a lot of people camping out with tents around by the river. So pretty exciting for the Lemurs to be here during this event. Unfortunately, we're leaving before the big event starts tomorrow. Here's Ryan Court. And the pitch is low. So once again, it's called the Register's Annual Great Bicycle Ride Across Iowa. And it's a non-competitive bicycle ride that's put on by the Des Moines Register. And it goes from the west to the east across the U.S. state of Iowa. One ball and no strikes to Court. Court 0-for-1 with a walk. And the pitch. Sue, that one misses inside. The event draws recreational riders from across the United States and from many foreign countries as well. And the first one was held back in 1973. In fact, one of the slogans is "Party like it's 1973." See a lot of that stuff around the Sioux City area. And it's the largest bike touring event in the world. Two balls and no strikes. The pitch. Swung in a hot shot. Line drive right to Silverio. He'll go down to a knee and snag it. Two down in the inning. So this is what happens. Riders begin in the community of Iowa's western border. And this year they're starting off in Sioux City. And they're going to ride to a community on the eastern border of Iowa. Along the way, they're going to stop at Storm Lake, Fort Dodge, Eldora, Cedar Falls, Hiawatha, and Coraville. And at the Iowa River landing finish near the waters of the Mississippi River in Davenport. So into the batter's box is Tommy Mendoza. Two down. So the ride is 1 week. It lasts 7 days, maybe a little bit longer for those slow pokes. And the pinch. Swung on a well-driven ball to right, but that's going to go foul. After beginning on the previous Sunday, so it starts tomorrow. The earliest possible start date is July 19th, which is tomorrow. And the latest date it can stop is on July 25th, which is next weekend. No balls and one strike. So shaking off is B.J. Hyatt now. Behind the plate is Luke Bailey's going to talk things over. So the Ragbrae holds an annual lottery which lakes 8,500 week-long riders. The lottery is held beginning on November 15th of the previous year up until April 1st. Random computer selection determines the participants. People are notified by email on May 1st as to the lottery results. And there are also passes on a first-come, first-served basis for 1,500 day riders. And these are limited to three per person. So it goes back to 1973. Pretty neat. As the pitch comes in for a strike. In fact, I was walking around downtown, and I don't know how many times I was asked, are you part of the bike ride coming up? And nope, just in here to work some baseball games. So pretty neat event. So what they do is, the whole thing is for people to have their bicycles, they dip them into the Missouri River with their back tire, and here's a check swing, and he went around, did Mendoza, and he's going to be out. So the people with the bikes, they dip their back tire in the Missouri River, and when they get over to the Mississippi River on the other side of the state, they dip their front tire in that river, and that's the end. You're all done after that. So it's a huge event here, and it's a lot of fun to see people filing in. Huey Lewis and the News are in town tonight to help kick off the event tomorrow. They're playing a concert just when we're leaving town. We're all bummed out. So that's going to do it here. We're going to the top of the seventh inning. The Lemurs are up 9-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. And the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn, Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined. And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
All right, the Lemurs coming up to the plate and a new pitcher up on the mound for Sioux City. It's Billy Bullock taking over. Lemurs will send Silverio Taylor and Medeiros up to the plate. As we go to the top of the seventh inning, almost stretch time here at the ballpark. It's a 9-1 lead for the Laredo Lemurs. A run in the first, two runs in the second, two runs in the fourth, and a big sixth inning where they put up four runs. And a two-run home run by Dustin Geiger to top it all off there in the sixth. So here's Silverio into the batter's box. And the pitch is a little bit low. So taking a look at the scoreboard from around the American Association, letting you know what's going on in the rest of the league. Some games are probably already in the books with some earlier starts here tonight. The 1-0 pitch in there for a strike. Yeah, Winnipeg and Gary, they're all done. They started at 6 o'clock, and I told you earlier, if you're listening, they played in 2 hours and 14 minutes. Winnipeg 10, Gary nothing. The 1-1 kick and throw. A curveball is high. Two balls and one strike now to Silverio. Silverio by the day, 0 for 3 on the day. Kansas City big over Lincoln. They win 11-0 over the Salt Doggies. And two balls and one strike. Bullock throws, and that one swung on and grounded foul. So we'll see a 2-2 pitch coming up now to Juan Silverio. St. Paul getting big over Sioux Falls. St. Paul's up 16-4. And the Joplin Blasters are beating the Amarillo Thunderheads 10-9. So the Lemurs are definitely keeping their eye on that one. The 2-2 pitch, breaking ball, swung on, popped up. Regular left field, Colwell coming in, and he's going to be right in the middle of left field out there, and he'll reach up and make the catch. And there's one down, and Kevin Taylor, the next batter. Wichita is up over Grand Prairie right now. They're in the seventh inning. It's a 4-2 lead for the Wichita Wingnuts. And Fargo and Sussex County back at it. Their rain delay has been lifted, and it's a 7-7 tie in the top of the ninth. So you have to go through a rain delay in Sussex County, and then next thing you know, you have a tie ball game that may go extra innings. So here's Kevin Taylor into the batter's box. He's 1-for-3 on the day. The delivery to Taylor is on the outside corner for a strike, a fastball there. Kevin Taylor, back in the second inning, singled and scored a run. He actually led off the inning with that single. 9-1 Laredo. And the pitch. Breaking ball hits the inside corner. So Billy Bullock gets the outside corner and then comes back in with a breaking ball and gets the inside corner of the plate. No balls and two strikes. No wind blowing here at the ballpark right now. The 0-2 pitch, another breaking ball that stays high. One ball, two strikes. And the pitch. High and away. Two balls and two strikes now to Taylor. So Taylor out of the batter's box for a moment. Now he'll go ahead and get back in. And Billy Bullock delivers. Swung in a ground ball over to the right side. Charging the second baseman, Ryan Court. He'll flip over to first base and get the out. That'll be the second out in the inning. Two down. Here comes Jared Medeiros to the plate. Lemurs with an 8-run lead. So Billy Bullock on the season, a 1-0 record and a 3.98 ERA through 17 games for Sioux City. Bullock so far this year has given up 15 runs. Nine of them have been earned through 20 and a third innings of work before tonight. Madero's having a good game. Look at him go. 4-for-4 with four runs scored tonight. His best game as a professional by far. This is rookie season just out of St. John's University. He swings here, pops one up into left center field. Coming in, Colwell, Johnson, and going out's Perio. Colwell will get there to the left fielder. He'll put it away amongst a triangle of Sioux City Explorers. And that'll be it for Medeiros. That'll be it for the Lemurs. They go down in order here in the top of the seventh. We'll head to the bottom of the seventh inning. 9-1 Laredo. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Breakfast speaks for itself here at Whataburger. It's going to be hot. It's going to be fresh.
It's almost like when you were a kid and you wake up in the morning, you can smell mom cooking breakfast.
I like their hash browns.
My favorite is the honey butter chicken biscuit. I like the taquitos.
We have some fresh cracked eggs here.
I like these pancakes because they're fluffy.
I really like the fact that you can get into Whataburger real fast and bring it on the go.
We're cooking breakfast for you at Whataburger.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings.
TAMIU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMIU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMIU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMIU.edu and get powered.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epic or chest bumps, touchdown dancing, breakdancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Hey, ¿tienes algo que celebrar? ¿Que le salió el primer diente a tu hijo? ¿Que tu abuelita aprendió a tuitear? ¿Que cambiaste tu cheque? La respuesta es la misma. Pues un carnesazo. No importa lo que estés celebrando, lo que importa es que lo celebres. Pues con un carnesazo de HEB. En HEB encuentras gran variedad de cortes a precios bajos y de buena calidad. Carnesazo. Carne asada con ganas. Solo en HEB.
We'd like to imagine that if you're listening to this, it's on a radio in a backyard in between innings. The grass was mowed this morning, and the grill smells like heaven. And what do you know? Your friends just arrived with a 24-pack of Miller Lite, along with a few new friends to enjoy them with. Here's hoping we're right, and you're not just stuck in traffic. Here's hoping it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. 2015 Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
All right, so we go off to the bottom of the seventh inning. It's 9-1 Laredo. Nine runs on 13 hits for the Lemurs. The Lemurs have made two errors so far tonight. One run on four hits for the Sioux City Explorers. And leading things off is going to be Matt Coach and a new pitcher up on the hill for the Laredo Lemurs. Ty Fletcher going to be making his first professional start. His first professional appearance as he steps up there on the hill. He's a left-handed pitcher. So we'll get to see what he's made out of here. He's been with the Lemurs for a few days, and this is the first time he's gotten to pitch. The Lemurs have pretty much been waiting for a situation just like this. And it's one ball and no strikes. Lemurs been waiting for them to be up in a ball game. So over the left field wall here at the ballpark, the 1-0. That one swung in on the ground ball up the third baseline, foul. Over the left field wall and over to center field wall and up in the distance, there is a soapbox racing racetrack. And it looks like some guys are out there with their lights on, running the track. Pretty interesting. So we'll keep an eye on that. They have their lights on up there and they're rolling down the track. One ball and one strike. The delivery is low and outside. So Ty Fletcher ended up going to South Carolina Sumter. That was his college. And he resides in Somerville, South Carolina. And he also attended the College of Charleston for a short time. So this is rookie season in professional baseball. The 2-1 swung on a fly ball hit into left center field. On the run, Devontre Richardson. He'll get there and make the catch. So the first out is made. We're in the bottom of the seventh inning. Lemurs up 9-1. Eno Patron, the next batter. While Fletcher was at the University of South Carolina Sumter, which is a junior college, in 2011 and 2012, he was 10-6 with a 2.80 ERA through 23 games. They're called the Fire Ants. The South Carolina Sumter Fire Ants. He had 106 strikeouts between the two seasons and 119 innings pitched. His freshman year, Fletcher pitched in 11 games and posted a 6-1 record with a 2.04 ERA with 48 strikeouts. And as a sophomore, he appeared in 12 games. Here's the batter, Eno Patron. He'll take a strike. And appeared in 12 games his freshman year, striking out 58 batters and put up a 4-5 record with a 3.50 ERA. The 0-1 pitch, breaking ball, swung on, hit well into right center field. On the run, Dennis Phipps. Phipps will have a tip off the end of his mitt, and it's going to roll further into right center field. Around second and heading into third base is Eno Patron. Here comes the throw from Taylor. The tag is... We're waiting for a call from the umpire as the ball falls to the ground, and the runner is going to be safe. Silverio laid down the tag. The ball was hidden underneath Eno Patron as Patron got up. The ball was on the ground. So a triple there for Patron. And Dilek Usiak coming up to the plate. Well, Phipps almost got to that one. It hit off the tip of his mitt and kept rolling out into further right center field and ended up going all the way out to the warning track. So here's Dylan Usiak. 9-1 Lemurs. They have a comfortable lead as of right now. Still some time to play. Sioux City, a very explosive team. So Patron at third base with one out. Here's the late kick and the pitch is a call to strike in the outside corner. No balls and one strike to the batter, Usiak. Usiak with two strikeouts in the ballgame. Fletcher out of the stretch. He kicks high, he throws home, and that one swung and fouled back to the fence. Well, if you're a young man like Ty Fletcher, you got to be excited. Your first professional appearance. He went to spring training with the Fargo-Moorhead Redhawks, but they just didn't have any room for him up there. So he ends up down here with the Laredo Lemurs after searching for a team to play with. No balls and two strikes. The Lemurs will have tomorrow off. Remember, no Sunday baseball for the Lemurs. The 0-2, breaking ball in the dirt. It goes between the legs of Luke Bailey. Coming home is Patron. The throwback to home plate is not going to be in time. In fact, it gets by the relief pitcher, Ty Fletcher. And backing it up is Kevin Taylor, but nobody on base to worry about now. That'll be a wild pitch, and the run comes in to score. It's now 9-2 in favor of Laredo. So the triple by Patron, he ends up coming in to score a run. A 1-2 count to Usiak, and all Fletcher has to worry about now is the guy in the batter's box. So Fletcher throwing to Luke Bailey, the catcher for Laredo. And the 1-2. A breaking ball in the dirt. Bailey going down to the ground and making sure he corrals that one. And the Lemurs might find time to put Mark Haynes in here as well. Haynes pitched the other day for the Laredo Lemurs in his first appearance of the season. And I thought the Lemurs were going to wait for a situation like this to put Haynes in. With the Lemurs having a big lead. The 2-2 pitch outside for ball, but the Lemurs put him right into the fire the other night. And Haynes ended up getting the 3 outs that he needed. And then the rain came and washed out the rest of the ball game, and then we had to switch it off to the next day. So 3 balls and 2 strikes. So Haynes pitched on Thursday. The 3-2. High for a ball. Ball 4. So Usiak walks. And Tim Colwell coming up to the plate. So Colwell, 1-for-2 in the ball game. He picked up a hit back in the 5th inning. And the Lemurs are going to be looking for a double play ball here. So Colwell, primarily why they went out and got Ty Fletcher for the Laredo Lemurs. They need another lefty in the bullpen because both Henry Garcia and Luis Pajorena, the two lefties that they had in the bullpen, have both been moved into the rotation. In fact, now the Lemurs have 3 lefties in the rotation with John Jones. That can always help out. The more lefties, the better. Here's the pitch. Outside for a ball. So 1 ball and no strikes to Tim Colwell. Matty Johnson is on deck. And a runner at first base, Dylan Usiak. 9-2 Lemurs. And the delivery swung on and a pop-up over to the left side. That's going to get back out of play. So a 1-1 count now to Tim Colwell. Well, Fletcher got the first out pretty easily, and then Eno Patron rocketed one into right center field, and it tipped off the glove of the outfielder Dennis Phipps for the Laredo Lemurs. Phipps was oh so close to making a catch there, but he did have a long run just to catch up to the baseball. Here comes the 1-1 delivery. Breaking ball. That finds the outside corner for a strike. Maddie Johnson's on deck for the Sioux City Explorers. Colwell, the number 9 hitter, up at the plate. And Fletcher throws the 1-2 pitch. High. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Another fastball from Fletcher. Fletcher wearing number 43 on his back, by the way, in case you're wondering, in case you want to mark that down in your scorebook. He's wearing number 43. 2-2. Fletcher looks at first base, now back at home, and throws. That is a high ball. Pitch misses away and high. 3 balls and 2 strikes. So a full count. Fletcher kicking some dirt away on the mound. He toes the rubber with his left foot. Looks in as he has rest his mitt on his thigh. And now he'll come set below the belt. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Outside, ball 4. Back-to-back walks. And Tim Colwell will reach first base, and that'll put runners at first and second. And the Lemurs are starting to get somebody warmed up down in the bullpen. And manager Pete Gavilla has seen enough. He's coming out of the dugout, and he will bring somebody new in. I believe that's Ryan Beckman throwing down in the bullpen right now, but we'll have to wait and see when he gets a little bit closer. The Lemurs are up 9-2. The Ty Fletcher experiment here in the 7th inning has been put to a stop, and we'll see what happens to the young man as we move forward throughout the season. Hopefully he'll be around for a little bit here. The Lemurs could use a good left-handed pitcher out of the bullpen. 9-2 Laredo. We're going to take a timeout here. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
South Texas families never strike out with Driscoll Health Plan. Catch the value-added services we pitch to our Medicaid members. Enjoy a free membership to specific Boys and Girls Clubs. Receive gift cards for completing Texas healthcare checkups. Restrictions and limitations may apply. Visit us at DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Todos sabemos que podemos lograr más cuando estamos listos. Por eso, decidí matricularme en Texas A&M International University. Quiero un título universitario y las oportunidades que me brindará. TAMIU me ha recibido a mí y a 7,000 estudiantes de todo el mundo. TAMIU me impulsa a ser grande, enciende mi mente y hace mi corazón latir. Imagina las posibilidades cuando eres impulsado por TAMIU.
Inscríbete ahora para verano y otoño. Visita TAMIU.edu y sé impulsado.
3, 2, 1, number one. That's Laredo's number one Chevy dealer. Family Chevrolet turns the best day ever into the best month ever. 15% off, not good enough, but 25% off, now that makes it the best month ever. With over 600 vehicles available, makes it the best pricing ever. 2015 Equinox, 2015 Traverse, not 15, but 25% off. And the best financing rates for the best month ever, 1.9 interest. Family Chevrolet of Laredo.com. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet. Family Chevrolet is the number one volume Chevy dealer for a reason. Every customer rides during our spring cleaning closeout sale with massive price gets on 600 Chevys. New 2015 Chevy Cruze. How about 25% off MSRP? Wow, that's huge. Or only $199 a month. New 2015 Malibu for only $269 a month. Or 25% off MSRP. Plus 2 years free maintenance and a 100,000-mile warranty. It's a spring cleaning closeout sale happening now at the number one volume Chevy dealer. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to fewer guys with beer bellies, which led to more women attracted to those guys, which led to dates, second dates, wedding bells, and honeymoons, which led to hubbada hubbada, boom, which led to you. Miller Lite. We invented light beer. And you. You're welcome.
All right, so Ryan Beckman comes out of the bullpen for the Laredo Lemurs as we move on here in this inning. We're in the bottom of the seventh inning. Lemurs up 9-2. And runners at first and second base for Sioux City. They have already scored a run here in the inning, and the top of the order is coming up to the plate, Matty Johnson. Beckman, the right-hander, will deliver. That is in there for a strike. Beckman starts the day with a record of 1 win and no losses, a 1.54 ERA. He has pitched in 26 games for the Laredo Lemurs. He has one save, has thrown in 35 innings with 23 hits given up, 7 runs, and 6 of them have been earned. He has walked only 4 batters and has struck out 26. The 0-1 swung on in a pop-up over to the left. That will get back out of play. Beckman's against average is 190. So he's done a good job here for the Laredo Lemurs so far this season. He has faced off against 127 batters. He currently has his 27th outing here. John Berbria leads the team in appearances. In fact, John Berbria is second in the league in appearances out of the bullpen. He's got 29 appearances on the mound this year. No balls and 2 strikes. The delivery. Called strike 3. Matty Johnson rung up. That'll be the second out in the inning. Michael Lang coming up to the plate. Runners at first and second base for Sioux City. Ryan Beckman has made 2 appearances so far in this series, so it's a 4-game set, and Beckman has pitched 2 of the games here, and this one being the third. So he pitched in the first game, took the next day off, and then pitched on the 17th against Sioux City when the Lemurs ended up losing 2-0, so he pitched in the second game and the 5-inning game that ended up getting rained out. So now Luke Bailey going to go talk things over with Ryan Beckman. So far for Beckman against Sioux City, he's pitched in 2 1/3. We'll make it 2 2/3 now with the out that he just got against Matty Johnson. He has not given up a run or a hit to any of the Sioux City Explorers. 9-2 Laredo. Here's Michael Lang. A couple of strikeouts for Lang today. Runners at first and second base and 2 down. Here's the pitch. Swung on and a pop-up over to the right side. Geiger going out. Taylor also going towards the right field line. Phipps is there, though, at the right field line. He'll reach up and make the catch with a little karaoke move. And that's going to do it for the Sioux City Explorers. But they strike here. Eno Patron gets a triple. He comes in to score on a wild pitch. Next 2 guys get walked. And Ryan Beckman comes out and puts out the fire for the Laredo Lemurs. We're heading to the 8th inning. Lemurs are up 9-2.
Crowd at the bar making you sweat?
Uh-huh.
Could you use some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in epic nights, maximum refreshment, great times, awesome memories, high fives, smiles, Rocky Mountain refreshment, Blue Mountain refreshment, quadruple epic refreshment, killer parties, and totally refreshed killer parties. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Kaila Norte, Suite Number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS, creating a new standard in medical transportation. Capital Care EMS, the official ambulance of your Laredo Lemurs.
Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Catholic College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Catholic College. Call 800-617-0800.
9-2 Laredo. They're coming up to the plate here in the eighth inning. Luke Bailey's going to lead it off, followed by Jayudy Valdez, and then we'll go up to the top of the order for Ty Morrison. And the Lemurs are going to be facing off against former major leaguer David Herndon. So Herndon, a big right-handed pitcher out there on the hill. Herndon, 6'5", 200 pounds out of Panama City, Florida. And the pitch to Bailey is a strike on the inside part of the plate. Yeah, Herndon played big league ball. He made his debut in the majors back on April 5th of 2010. He was 24 years old at the time. Here comes the 0-1 pitch. It's low for a ball. And when he pitched, he was pitching for the Philadelphia Phillies, and he pitched against the Washington Nationals. Threw an inning, gave up two hits, struck out a batter, didn't walk anybody, and didn't have any earned runs go against him. The 1-1 delivery, swung on at a broken bat, pop up over into the stands. And I believe Bailey broke his bat. He's going to check it, and indeed, it's broken. One ball and two strikes. Lemurs up 9-2. The last game that Herndon pitched in Major League Baseball, he was 26 years old, and he pitched against the Chicago Cubs, threw in two innings, gave up three hits, struck out a batter, didn't walk anybody, and gave up two earned runs. So while he was with Philadelphia, he wore number 57. He was there in 2010, 2011, and 2012. So he had a stint in the big leagues. His overall time in the big leagues, he put up a 2-8 record and a 3.85 ERA. He pitched in 97 total big league games. So how much money do you make for that much time in the big leagues? Over three seasons and 97 games. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swung on and tapped up the third baseline. It's going to go foul. So Herndon, in his time in the majors, made $1,320,000. And it says here that it might be an incomplete number, but that's about right. Not a bad lump of change there. Over $1 million. Well, hopefully he kept a little bit of it. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Strike three. Luke Bailey strikes out to start off the eighth inning, and there's one down here. Jayudy Valdez coming up to the plate. He's having a good day after struggling for a while with the Laredo Lemurs. But he had a couple of days off to get his head straight, and it looks like it's screwed back on nice and tight. Jayudy Valdez tripled in the fourth inning, came around to score a run. He also drove in Medeiros with that base hit. Then he doubled back in the sixth inning and picked up two RBIs there. So the couple of days off for Jayudy Valdez may have treated him right. And the pitch. That is inside for a ball from Herndon. Herndon, the right-handed pitcher, gets the sign from the catcher. And the 1-0. Curveball falls in there for a strike. Herndon, throughout the minor leagues, He was first drafted by the Kansas City Royals in the 38th round back in 2004 out of high school. He decided not to come out then. Then the Minnesota Twins grabbed him in the 23rd round back in 2005 out of his community college in Panama City. The 1-1. A check swing, and they're going to check down with the first base umpire. He says he did not go around. Two balls and one strike. And then the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim were finally able to wrangle him at a community college in the Gulf Coast Community College in Panama City in the fifth round of 2006. The pitch, swung on, broken bat, slow roller up the third baseline, and they're going to try to let it go foul, but it's actually going to hit the bag, and it's going to be a base hit for Jayudy Valdez. So three hits tonight for Jayudy, and he's a home run short of the cycle. And his bat got broken on that hit. And it died a good soldier. The ball ended up hugging the line down the third baseline. It ended up hitting the lip of the grass on the right side and kind of kicked a little bit over to the left, but it was able to hit the bag and ended up being a fair ball. Here's Ty Morrison into the batter's box, another good hitter for the Laredo Lemurs right now. He's got two hits in the game. He's officially 2-for-2. He walked in the second and laid down a sack bunt in the sixth. So a runner at first base and a 9-2 lead for the Lemurs. Here's the pitch, and that one misses outside. So throughout the minor leagues for Herndon, he pitched for the Orem Owls, the Cedar Rapids Colonels, the Rancho Cucamonga Quakes. He saw times with the Arkansas Travelers. The 1-0. Outside for a ball. He also pitched in the Dominican Winter League. Saw a short time with the Phillies minor league system, the Lehigh Valley Iron Pigs, and then got moved up to the big leagues and pitched for the Phillies. After leaving the Phillies, he pitched a few years in the Yankees system. The 2-0, high for a ball, but he never made it to the big leagues with the New York Yankees. In fact, last year he was in Scranton-Wilkes-Barre, and that's home of the Rail Riders, a Yankees affiliate. That's their AAA affiliate. So he was there for 5 games last season before getting released. And then he finds himself here with the Sioux City Explorers this season. 3 balls and no strikes. He's primarily worked as a reliever in his career, 171 games and 54 starts. The 3-0 is called a strike. Always neat when we're able to run by the former major leaguers, guys that spent some time in the big leagues and have some neat stories to tell. And Herndon spent a lot of time up there. 3 balls and 1 strike. The kick and the throw home is swung and a ground ball over to the second baseman. Court has it. He'll flip to second for 1. Back over to first base, and that's a double play. That'll end the top of the 8th inning for the Laredo Lemurs. We'll head to the bottom of the 8th. Lemurs are up 9-2. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Today at Whataburger, we're cooking the Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. The chicken is hot and fresh. It's got melted Monterey Jack cheese topped with lettuce, tomato, bacon, and then the honey mustard adds a nice sweet flavor to it.
All the flavors come together just perfect. I mean, not only do I want to eat it, but I keep wanting to look at it.
The crunchiness of the bacon adds a really nice texture.
Honey mustard and chicken just go together. You know, sweet and savory, it's a perfect mix.
Try the new Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club.
Only at Whataburger for a limited time.
Hey Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at LaredoLemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Texas Inflatable Rentals has Laredo's largest water slides. We are proud to say that we serve the greater Laredo area and supply slip sliding fun for kids of all ages. Texas Inflatable Rentals has a huge selection of inflatables for every budget. And to add to the party, we rent tables, chairs, snow cone machines, popcorn machines, and cotton candy machines that will help take your party to the next level. We also have moonwalks and bounce houses. Contact Texas Inflatable Rentals at 956-436-3909 or at TexasInflatableRentals.com. And book with the coupon code LEMURS for a 10% discount. That's Texas Inflatable Reynolds, Laredo's largest water slide.
Driscoll Health Plan loads the bases with value. We knock it out of the park with all the value-added services we bring to our Medicaid members. Driscoll families cheer on the Grand Slam packages, sports physicals, free memberships to Boys and Girls Clubs, and dental care for pregnant women over 21. Take a swing at our baby showers offered by Cadena de Madre. Forget those peanuts and Cracker Jacks, root for our baby blankets and more. Come slide into home when you receive gift cards for completing Texas Health Steps checkups and attending postpartum visits on time. Don't miss a play. Restrictions and limits may apply. Visit DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Looking to travel this summer? If the year-round flights to Las Vegas aren't fit for you, take advantage of Allegiant's direct flights from Laredo International Airport to Orlando. For as low as $119 round trip, you and your family can be in Orlando in 2.5 hours. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. Texas Outlaw. De La Cruz. All right, Luis De La Cruz taking over on the hill for the Laredo Lemurs as we move on to the bottom of the 8th inning. So for the Explorers, Noah Perio coming up. Ryan Court will follow. And Tommy Mendoza will be coming up to the plate. So Luis De La Cruz up on the mound now for Laredo. Ryan Beckman's night is done. And we haven't seen De La Cruz on the mound since July 13th against the Amarillo Thunderheads. He pitched a third of an inning back then and gave up 2 hits. He's got a 1-2 record overall and a 6 ERA with the Lemurs. He has pitched in 9 games now. This will be his 10th for the Lemurs. The pitch. Swung, and that's fouled away. Perillo with a base hit today. He got a base hit back in the 4th inning. He's officially 1-for-3. De La Cruz. Throughout his time up on the mound for the Laredo Lemurs, through nine innings, has given up six runs as he throws low. And it's one ball and one strike. 9-2 Laredo. De La Cruz works out of the stretch. Tall right-hander, 6'6", 225 pounds out of the Padres organization. And the 1-1 delivery. Swung on and fouled away again. One ball and two strikes. So a lefty-righty matchup. Perillo, a left-handed batter, a right-handed pitcher. Up there on the hill, De La Cruz, he'll fire away, and that is a check swing. They'll check down with the third base umpire. He did not go around. At the banks of the Missouri River, they'll start the race. Then they'll travel on their bikes across the state of Iowa to the mighty Mississippi. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch by De La Cruz. Swung in a ground ball over to the first baseman. Geiger with a nice backhand. He'll race over to the bag at first and touch the bag. Three unassisted in your scorebook, and Ryan Court coming up to the plate. Well, besides the great bike race here in town, Huey Lewis and the News are in town tonight. Yay, here in Sioux City. But unfortunately, we're probably missing that right now. They're probably rocking and rolling out there in downtown Sioux City at this point. But I was able to take a look at the museum today in Sioux City, which was pretty neat. The Sioux City Public Museum. Pretty close to our hotel. I think it was a full block away. Here's the pitch. That is low and inside. We were able to stay in a downtown hotel here today. I wish most of the teams, or all the teams for that matter, would put us up in their downtown areas. That's always nice to be able to see a little culture and history of the city that you're in. One ball and no strikes. But sometimes it's just not affordable. And the 1-0 pitch. Swung in a ground ball foul up the first baseline. So as I went to the Sioux City Museum, I was able to check one thing out that really stood out to me. The Corn Palace of Sioux City. It was really neat. Workers built a wooden structure, and every inch of wood was covered with corn. It was also covered with grain starting back in 1887, and they kept building them through 1891. One ball and one strike. It was pretty amazing. I'll tell you a little bit more about it. Here's the 1-1 pitch, low and outside. So they had ears of brightly colored Indian corn, which were sliced and nailed into fancy patterns. And above each arched doorway, a farming scene was created from corn and grain. The windows were framed with ears of corn and was strung on wires. And the roof was put together with stalks of grain. Here's the pitch, and that one's outside. Three balls and one strike. The Corn Palace Committee hired an architect to create the plans for the first Corn Palace structure way back in 1887, back when I was a youngster, back in 1887. Three balls and one strike. And the original plan for this structure, now get this, this is where it gets exciting. The three ball, one strike pitch is outside. That'll be ball four to Ryan Court. Tommy Mendoza coming up to the plate. So yeah, this is where it gets really exciting. The original plan called for the building to be 58 feet by 58 feet, and to be built on the northwest corner of 5th Street and Jackson. However, the plan soon decided to enlarge it by 100 feet by 100 feet. So you're talking a wooden structure, 100 feet by 100 feet. And then they would pound the corn on there and, you know, put it up with wire and hammer it on there as well. So this full structure, 100 foot by 100 foot, would all have corn on it, the pitch. Swung on a miss. And when I say a corn palace, the ball gets away from Bailey and heading up the second base is Ryan Court. So Mendoza swings and misses, and the ball bounces away from Bailey, and the runner goes up to second. So that'll be a wild pitch. But if you can see pictures of this thing, when I say it's a corn palace, it is literally a palace made out of corn and wood. I mean, these things were absolutely beautiful. So after the 100 feet by 100 feet plan, it was again enlarged to include a Goldie roller rink, and the final size of the Corn Palace, the first one, encompassed more than 18,000 square feet of floor space. Basically, they're building a palace, a real palace, No balls and two strikes as the next pitch is fouled off. So as time went by, the budget got bigger and bigger for the program. The original budget was $5,000, and that got raised up to $25,000 for the first one. And the work on the palace could continue. And if you just go and take a look at these things, they're pretty amazing. And they're called Corn Palaces of Sioux City. And you can find them on Google, I'm sure, if you decide to look them up and look at the pictures. No balls and two strikes. And a runner at first base. I mean, there was a lot of things in there, you know, about the history of Sioux City. But for some reason, that just stood out to me, these big corn palaces. Now Luke Bailey with a visit up to the mound. A runner at second base, and the Lemurs are up 9-2. We're having Corn Palace talk here with the Laredo Lemurs. You can feel free to call in 1-800-CORN-PALACE. That's your phone number to dial in and talk a little bit about corn palaces from Sioux City. No balls and two strikes. The fire home from De La Cruz, and it misses very high. So one ball and two strikes. So the reason they were building these corn palaces was basically to celebrate the harvest of the corn. One ball and two strikes. And the pitch. Outside for a ball. So if you want to see the corn palaces, you can go to siouxcityhistory.org. They have a lot of information about the corn palaces. In fact, I'll go ahead and link that up to Twitter right now so you can find it very easily. And De La Cruz steps off the back of the rubber. So if you got us on Twitter, we're at L. Lemurs Baseball. That's right, L. Lemurs Baseball. And a ground ball over to the second baseman. Taylor's in front of it. He'll flip over to first base. He pulls Geiger off of the bag, and Geiger will be off of the bag far enough where he can't get back to tag the bag. So Ryan Court moves up to third. It's going to be an error on the second baseman, Taylor. And a rare error on him, only his second of the season. And Matt Coach coming up to the plate. All right, so I am linking it up now to at Lemurs Baseball, or at L. Lemurs Baseball. And if you want to find it and take a look at these cool corn palaces and get an eyeball full of them like I did. Of course, they came to life a little bit better when you're in the museum. I don't think they'll be quite as intriguing as you look at them online, but still pretty neat. And when you look at the sizes of these things, one of them, back in 1891, the corn palace had over a 200-foot tower. Runners at the corners and one out. A 9-2 lead for the Lemurs. Here's the pitch. Swung in a ground ball, hard hit down the third baseline. Foul. And these corn palaces were built right in the downtown area for everybody to come and enjoy them. I wish I could find, and I'm sure it's somewhere in here, where it says how many ears of corn were actually used to make the corn palaces. No balls and one strike. And De La Cruz throws. That one swung on and fouled back into the fence. I mean, could you imagine seeing this thing from a distance, not knowing what it was, and all of a sudden you see this big Taj Mahal looking thing in the middle of Sioux City. And as you get closer and closer, you're starting to realize that it's made out of corn. Well, they had big festivals around the corn palaces, so it all had to do with throwing a big party. Throwing a big party back in the 1890s. Woo, the 0-2, high and tight. One ball and two strikes. See other things in the museum that they had a bunch of fire engines, they had a bunch of stuff that had to do with the crops and the cattle here in the area. One ball and two strikes. Always neat to go to the museums in the cities that you're in. The 1-2 pitch. In tight again. Two balls and two strikes. Somebody warming up down in the Lemurs bullpen. Once again, a little bit too far away for me to tell exactly who it is. So I'll refrain from saying a name because I'm not 100% sure. Two balls and two strikes. We need a ticker that says who's warming up in the bullpens at every ballpark. The 2-2. Swung on and a soft liner up to the second baseman. Taylor's going to try to run down the runner going between first and second. He'll flip over to second, first base, and get the double play. So he tagged Mendoza as Mendoza was trying to backpedal out of the way. And then he flipped quickly over to get Matt Coach out at first base. And Mendoza is beside himself. He thought he was safe over there between first and second as he kept running up to second base. Nonetheless, the inning comes to an end on a double play ball. Taylor tags Mendoza and then gets Matt Coach out at first. Well, that is it for the inning. We're going to go to the top of the ninth. Lemurs up 9-2, and I'm sorry, we're out of time here for Corn Palace Talk. We'll be back with more in the ninth inning. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic, the official team doctors of your Laredo Lemurs, now with two convenient locations to better serve you. Our north location is located at 9652 McPherson Road, Suite 12. Our south location is located at 5102 State Highway 359. Laredo Sports Medicine offers an array of services from physical therapy to our newest service, orthopedic surgery. Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic is changing orthopedic care one athlete at a time. Visit our website at laredosportsmed.com for more information.
This summer, Allegiant will increase to 4 weekly flights to Las Vegas, Nevada. If gambling in Vegas isn't your thing, Allegiant is also increasing to 2 weekly flights to Orlando. Enjoy the Disney theme parks, Legoland, Universal Studios, SeaWorld, and the Kennedy Space Center. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials.
Welcome to Whataburger. Today we're cooking the sweet and spicy bacon burger.
Wow, it's beautiful.
Two beef patties, American cheese, Monterey Jack cheese, bacon, grilled onions, the sweet and spicy pepper sauce.
Sweet in the front and then the spicy in the back. I like it. I like it a lot.
So it's like a perfect balance, and then that bacon right there, it adds crunchiness.
I'll get back in line and get another one, I'll tell you that much.
Sweet spicy bacon burger. Come down to Whataburger. It's only here for a limited time.
All right, Jose Flores up on the mound for Sioux City. 9-2 Laredo as we go to the top of the ninth inning. And between innings, the manager for the Sioux City Explorers, Steve Montgomery, was tossed out of the ball game. He kept arguing about that play between first and second and the one at first base as well, and probably some other plays throughout the series here with this same umpiring crew. He probably was just going in and get a little steam off of his chest. So Devontre Richardson coming up to the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. Richardson on the night. He's 2-for-4. A couple of singles and a couple of RBIs. And Devontre into the batter's box, ready to go. With the pitcher Jose Flores up there on the hill. So Flores a righty. He'll throw home and a pitch that misses up and in. It's a fastball. Flores on the season, no wins and one loss, a 2.84 ERA through 19 games. He has 13 saves on the season. So Flores just getting a workout in here tonight. The pitch swung on and fouled back. No save opportunity for him right now. Flores started his career in professional baseball back at the age of 18 with the Cleveland Indians organization. He was pitching in the Dominican Summer League. That season, he appeared in 14 games, starting 12, and put up an 0-7 record with a 6.04 ERA. Here's the 1-1 breaking ball, and that comes in and hits Devontre Richardson. So a breaking ball gets a piece of Richardson, I believe, somewhere on the shoulder. And now Dustin Geiger coming up to the plate. 9-2 Laredo. Well, Dustin Geiger in his last at bat hit a long fly ball down the left field line. It ended up hitting the fair pole down the left field line. Some people like to call it the foul pole, but it's a fair pole because it's fair when the ball hits it. Geiger with two base hits today, that two-run home run, and a single back in the first inning. That home run for him was his 11th of the season, and he swings away here and misses, trying to play launch a ball once again. No balls and one strike. So during the post-game show, we'll go ahead and give you the scores from around the American Association. And the 0-1. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Geiger put a good swing on it, but the ball just kept going away from him. So an 0-2 count to Geiger. It'll be interesting to see who the Lemurs throw out there in the bottom of the ninth inning. No balls and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Swung on and tipped into the catcher's glove. He's able to hold on to it barely. He had a super snow cone going. So a strikeout there. And there's one down. And Dennis Phipps coming up to the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. Well, Phipps officially 0 for 2 today, but he did have a sacrifice fly that drove in a run back in the first. And he also walked back in the fifth inning, so he was on base back in the fifth. Here's the pitch to Phipps, and he swings and grounds one. One hopped right back to the pitcher. He throws over to second base for Perillo. Perillo will throw over to first base, and that's a double play. The third double play turned in tonight by Sioux City. And we're going to head to the bottom of the ninth inning. The Lemurs are up 9-2. A quick inning there. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E, that's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's got to be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Do you want to sit in a car for 7 hours, risk a flat tire, traffic, or highway construction delays? Fly direct from Laredo International Airport to Dallas-Fort Worth on American Airlines. From Dallas, you can change planes and take a flight to Tokyo, London, or even Rio de Janeiro. With 4 daily arrivals and departures, American Airlines is sure to have a connection that works best for you. So avoid spending hours in the car or risk an accident on the highway or even a flat tire. Fly in comfort from Laredo International Airport. Visit AA.com for details and to book a reservation.
Uni-Trade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Uni-Trade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Uni-Trade.
There's a reason why Popeyes creates some of the best tasting chicken in the world. We were born in New Orleans, Louisiana, the land of good fun and great cooking. Spicy flavor is a way of life in New Orleans, and everything we make reflects it. From our Popeyes bona fide chicken and handcrafted tenders to our home-style mashed potatoes with Cajun gravy and our soft, buttery biscuits, everything we make is made with care and served up fresh. Only at Popeyes.
Chavarrias Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology, trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit ChavarriasPlumbing.com and go Lemurs!
Patron! All right, Eno Patron to lead things off for Sioux City. It's 7-8-9 in the batting order, and Johan Montero on the pitch for the Laredo Lemurs as he's going to try to lock down the victory here for the Lemurs. So Ina Patron in his last at bat, he tripled and ended up coming in to score a run. He'll see a fastball here and he'll foul it off. So Johan Montero doing well for the Laredo Lemurs up there on the mound. And Montero delivers again, and that one swung and pounded into the ground. So no balls and two strikes to the batter, Eno Patron. Patron officially 1-for-3 with that triple. Montero 1-2 on the year with a 4.29 ERA. He's making his 14th appearance right now for the Laredo Lemurs. And the 0-2 pitch, low. So another reminder for you, no Lemurs baseball tomorrow. We will be traveling home. The Lemurs will be picking up with the Joplin Blasters on Monday, a divisional rival. Brand new team in the American Association, and the 1-2 delivery. Low for a ball. Two balls and two strikes. That was the fastball there from Johan Montero. So the Lemurs are welcoming in Joplin and Wichita. Should be a fun 7 games. Both divisional rivals, both teams above the Laredo Lemurs in the division. Here's a ground ball over to the shortstop. Maderos will flip one over to first base, and that'll be in time to get Patron out. So 6-3 put out and one down. 9 runs on 14 hits for the Lemurs tonight. 2 runs on 5 hits for Sioux City. They already moved on to Wichita. The Lemurs on the 27th and the 28th will have back-to-back days off this year. So they're going to ride that homestand into back-to-back days off before they head on up to Joplin for 3 games. So it should be a nice little homestand that'll extend into a couple of days off for the Laredo Lemurs. Here's the pitch to Dylan Usiak. That is low for a ball. And the Lemurs will not see another day off until August 17th. So it's going to be another long ride for the Laredo Lemurs before they get another regular scheduled day off. As the pitch comes in, and that one misses low. Actually, scratch that. They're going to be off again on the 1st, and then the 17th will be the next day off. Here's the 1-0. Swung on and missed. So the Lemurs playing, remember they played 32 straight up until they had a day off to come up here to Sioux City. The 1-1 pitch. Swung on, and that's tipped in and out of the glove of the catcher. 1-2. Lemurs up by 7. We're in the bottom of the 9th inning. Lemurs looking to lock this one down. And they're going to be looking to split the series. If they win this one, they'll split the series at 2 apiece. The 1-2 pitch. Swung in at a fly ball. Hit high in the air into left field. Richardson has got this one under control. He'll lean over to his left and make the catch. And 2 down. Tim Colwell will be the next batter. And tonight it's 9 runs on 14 hits for Laredo. 2 runs on 5 hits for Sioux City. So the number 9 batter, Tim Colwell, stepping into the batter's box. He's 1-for-2 with a walk. Montero delivers a breaking ball, misses low and inside. Colwell waves the bat over the plate. Here's the pitch by Montero. Low. 2-0. And the kick and the throw home. A strike on the outside corner. Well, the crowd starting to file out slowly here at the ballpark. The attendance tonight is 17-18. The 2-1 pitch swung on a fly ball hit into center field. Morrison looking at it. He'll go over to his left. He'll reach out to his left and make the catch. And that's going to be it for the ball game. In the 9th inning, the Sioux City Explorers are retired in order at the hands of Johan Montero. Your final score is the Lemurs 9, Sioux City 2. We're going to take a timeout and have the postgame show. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Thanks for joining us for Laredo Lemurs Baseball, brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarrias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Getter Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade 40, Whataburger of Alice. The Laredo Lemurs Post Game Show is coming your way next.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined. And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
Breakfast speaks for itself here at Whataburger. It's going to be hot, it's going to be fresh.
It's almost like when you were a kid and you wake up in the morning, you can smell mom cooking breakfast.
I like their hash browns.
My favorite is the honey butter chicken biscuit. I like the taquitos.
We have some fresh cracked eggs here.
I like these pancakes because they're fluffy.
I really like the fact that you can get into Whataburger real fast and bring it on the go.
We're cooking breakfast for you at Whataburger.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epicer chest bumps, touchdown dancing, breakdancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Now it's time for the Laredo Lemurs Post Game Show. Laredo Lemurs Baseball is brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarrias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Guerra Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade Boarding, Whataburger of Alice. Now here's Bill Harrington with Laredo Lemurs Post Game Show.
All right, Lemurs fans, thanks for sticking around for the Post Game Show. Bill Harrington coming to you live from Lewis and Clark Park in Sioux City, Iowa, as the Lemurs win tonight by a final score of 9-2. It was 9 runs on 14 hits with 3 errors tonight for the Laredo Lemurs. 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors for the Sioux City Explorers. Matt Lucen gets the victory here tonight. He moves to 3-3 on the season. He pitched in 5 innings, gave up 4 runs, only 1, or excuse me, 4 hits, only 1 run. It was earned. He walked 3 and struck out 6. Eric Werdekemper, he ends up getting the start and the loss here in the ballgame for Sioux City. He moves to 3-2 on the year. He went 3 1/3, gave up 7 hits, 5 runs, all earned. He walked a batter and struck out 2 here tonight. The game was played in 3 hours and 23 minutes in front of a crowd of 1,718 people here at the ballpark. And really a big night for the Laredo Lemurs bottom half of the order. Jared Medeiros ended up going 3-for-4 in the night with 3 singles, and he scored 3 runs for the Laredo Lemurs, a run in the second, a run in the fourth, and a run in the sixth inning. Luke Bailey picked up a double in the sixth inning. He came around to score. And J.U.D. Valdez, who had a couple of days off, and after those days off, he was in a slump. He got those days off. He comes back and goes 3-for-4 in the night with a triple, a single, and a double to his credit. So he was a home run shy hitting for the cycle here tonight. He also had 2 runs scored and 3 RBIs this evening. Dustin Geiger, a big contributor tonight. His 11th home run on the season. It was a 2-run homer in the 6th inning that brought home J.U.D. Valdez. And that was a 4-run inning for the Laredo Lemurs back in the 6th. So the Lemurs go on and roll in this ballgame. And a big part of this series was the Lemurs end up getting a split against a very good baseball team, the Sioux City Explorers. The Lemurs split it 2 apiece. They lose the first game, win the second game, lose the third game, and win the fourth game of the series before heading on out of here. So it's just a quick road trip for the Laredo Lemurs as they come up right to Sioux City, and now they're going to be heading right back home to Laredo, Texas. So going to be a long bus ride ahead, but the Lemurs are going to have a day off tomorrow. They'll get into Laredo sometime around 6 p.m., I'm guessing, as long as everything goes as planned. And then they'll have the rest of the evening off to relax, and then they'll go right back at it with Joplin. The very next day, the Joplin Blasters will be rolling in town on Monday as the Lemurs start a seven-game homestand. Joplin and Wichita coming into town, and then the Lemurs will have 2 days off for what would have been the All-Star break. No All-Star break, though, this season, but a couple of days off will be much appreciated by everybody in the organization, believe you me. So a good game here by the Laredo Lemurs tonight. Let's go and get you the scoreboard from around the American Association as everything's in the books, and then we'll go ahead and look at the South Division and see how everything stands at the end of the night. Winnipeg wins over Gary 10-0. Kansas City crushes Lincoln 11-0. So a lot of big scores tonight. Wow, looking all over the place, there's a lot of big ones. Joplin 11, Amarillo 9. That one's in the books. St. Paul 15, Sioux Falls 4. Wichita beats Grand Prairie 4-2. They'll stay in first place all by themselves with the Wichita Wingnuts. Sussex County comes back and wins a game in 10 innings over Fargo-Moorhead. An 8-7 final there. And you know the final score here. It's 9-2 Laredo. So a quick look at the standings, and then we'll wrap it up and call it a night. In the South Division, the Wichita Wingnuts are in first place. They're 32-22, and they're a game up over the Joplin Blasters, who are 30-22 on the year. The Laredo Lemurs at 29-26 after the victory. They're 3.5 games out. And Amarillo's right behind us. They're 6.5 games out with a record of 26-29. Grand Prairie bringing up the rear in the South. Sioux City still in first place in their division. They're in the Central. They're 37-17 with Kansas City right behind them at 5.5 games back. And St. Paul leads the North. They're crushing everybody. They have 42 wins and 12 losses. And Winnipeg is 18.5 games behind them. So that division pretty much wrapped up for St. Paul as long as they keep rolling off wins for themselves. That is an exciting baseball team. They're going to be tough to beat in the playoffs, whoever gets to meet them. So that's going to do it for the broadcast tonight. Thank you so much for sticking with us. I know we had a tough beginning to this one, but it turns out to be okay as the Laredo Lemurs pull out the 9-2 win. We're going to see you back at home on Monday night. Remember, we're going to be on the American Association Baseball.tv website, and we'll tweet it out before the game gets started. I'll have Cameron Songer next to me when we get home, so that should be exciting as well. My name is Bill Harrington, and thank you so much for joining us, everybody. We're signing off here from Sioux City, Iowa, and we're going to get ready to have a long trip home. We're sure we'll enjoy it. You've been listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. Good night, everybody.
Thanks for joining us for Laredo Lemurs Baseball, brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarrias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Guerra Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade Forwarding, Whataburger of Alice. Join us next time for all your Laredo Lemurs action.